Today's You Know What Do podcast on riotcast.com.
All right. Bam, boom, bam, ba-da-da, all right. Boom, boom, bum, ba-da-ba, all right.
Yeah, it's a good song. Hey, Bob.
I just made up my own words to it. What do you think?
I love it.
Thank you, Lauren, for being a part of the team.
Oh, right. I forgot.
Being one of the letters in team instead of being in a whole nother word. You're a C in the letter in the word team.
Ooh, what's that?
You put the deepu in.
Wow. Look at that hat. What the fuck is up with that hat? What
Super
camera
Bowl
are we looking
Long
at?
Island. Super Bowl Long Island.
Apparently. Oh, my God. Look at that fucking hat. Oh, God. Oh God.
If anyone has one of those hats that says the Falcons won the Super Bowl, I would love one, and I'll pay good money for it.
I have a Guatemalan friend of mine has one of those. Hello. What's up?
Doing well, man. How are you doing?
Happy Valentine's Day to both of you friggin' bitches.
I was going to ask you, will you be my Valentine?
Stop. You don't want me to be your
Please.
Valentine.
Please.
Yes, I'm your
Valentine.
Okay,
thank you. I got you chocolate, and I got deep-fried chocolate, too.
Oh, isn't that nice?
Yeah. Yes.
It's the tiny one.
Are you guys getting along?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're getting along pretty well.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
I was nice to her today because I learned that she recently got with a guy. I don't want to say, you know, no one knows this person, but...
what do you mean? Everybody knows who it is.
Right,
everybody knows.
Gate.
But she was telling me that one of the things she liked about this person was that he was nice to her. And when I realized that, I was like, I should have been nice to you.
Yeah, you would have had.
She's really hot.
She's hot, and you're mediocre, and you would have got. And the guy she's banging is definitely mediocre.
Yeah. I love you, Bob, and I want you to be my Valentine.
Yeah, I'll be your Valentine.
Okay, what are you gonna do?
Well, I'm fucking let you suck it.
Squash you.
I'm gonna jerk off on your cheek.
Lauren's gonna come in one day flattened like a pancake.
Sorry, dude. No, dude, I deserve it.
If she banged me, she would have come in here unsatisfied sexually.
So. Yes.
You don't know.
She's
going to
be flat and, flat and unsatisfied with me. I really can't. I got
super hairy.
Deepu, that's his culture. Yeah. His mother won't let him marry you unless you're that hairy. Her eyebrow hair and pubic hair do not connect. She is not a woman for you. It's Valentine's Day, everybody. Happy Valentine's Day. If you have somebody, call them right now. Text them. Send an emoji that you love them. Let them know. And if you don't have anybody, go jerk off in the bathroom.
Ooh, yeah. Mm.
Go jerk off in the bathroom. Lauren, look in the camera. Look in the camera. What are you? What is that, for snuff film people?
I'm really congested.
Who's your Valentine?
I have a Valentine. I'm not going to say her name.
Make up a name. We're not going to investigate. You have a girlfriend.
I have a girlfriend.
Is she Indian?
No, she's not.
Is she black?
No, she's not.
Is she Puerto Rican?
No, she's not.
Is she white?
It's an obscure
Is
one.
She Jewish?
So, well, the point is, we're going
to... Hawaiian?
No.
Filipino?
No. I got some hard...
Haitian?
A troll?
No, she's a good fan. And I got her some heart-shaped ravioli today.
Really?
I feel like that's cute.
She's Italian.
No.
What is she?
She's Iraqi.
Oh my God.
Buddy, I'm going to...
Down with America.
One of these days, the fucking FBI is going to kick that door in.
I do worry about
fucking
that.
We're all going to be wrapped up and detained. I'm going to miss a gig because of you.
I would be pregnant.
Because you and
baby.
Your fucking girlfriend, she's just using you.
Some guy at customs is going to be like, who is Deepu?
Well, that's actually every crowd you've ever performed in front of. What? Back at you for the fat joke.
Should I change my name? Is it too late to do that?
No,
you should keep your name because nobody has that name. Deepu. What's up? It's Deepu.
Yeah.
You're an idiot. What do you want to be? Bob? What's your name? Bob? Rob? Bobby? What should I call you?
Could go by my actual name.
What's your actual name?
Umardeep.
Dude, I'm calling you that from now on.
Umardeep.
It's almost as bad as your songs for Good Fan, Bad Fan. Speaking of which, we have anything, you guys, what's going on?
I love Deepu so much
what?
That I wrote him a love poem for Valentine's Day.
Okay, let's do this weird shit. I'm going to take a sip of my new bottle.
Okay. Wait, is it hooked up to your iPhone?
Mm-hmm. Music, hold on, music.
Okay. I'll use my sexy voice.
Yeah, use your sexy voice. Ugh, he's fucking smoking in Parliament 100s.
No, I can't smoke anymore. Okay.
Here we go.
Deepu. Roses are red. Violets are blue. Deepu's a hairy monkey, and I am one too.
That's true.
I'm excited when you don't call or text, and I love not seeing you. Hey, isn't it funny that we're never going to screw?
Oh, my God.
Oh, that actually hurt.
Sometimes you're mean. Sometimes you're nice. Sometimes I want to run you over with my car when we're in a fight.
Jesus.
You're truly a weirdo in every sense of the term. Now get back on the computer, you fucking nerd.
Oh. Is that it?
That's it.
That was pretty good. Yeah. I like that. I gotta put my little chubby hip in the mic. Fuck, I'm a fat fuck.
The whole get back on the computer thing, I bet she was sitting on that for months. That's what it felt like.
I actually gave her that line. No, I'm kidding. No, I dropped a Reese's. That's gone.
I guess, it's gone forever.
You dropped it in the most
Go down. Come on, Valentine. Get that. Get that Reese's. Wait a minute. Get it again.
That's so creepy.
Get it again.
Thank you, Lauren.
You're welcome.
Do you have a poem?
I do.
You do?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, this is queer.
It's less of a poem.
This is the queerest thing we've ever done on the show.
It's less of a poem. I thought we could just do like a love letter, a passive-aggressive love letter.
Right. So yours don't rhyme.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to choke on Reese's.
All right.
Don't choke. You're my Valentine.
Dearest Lauren. Lauren Kubera. Lauren, who cares?
Oh my God.
My love for you shines like a headlight in a junkyard. There are so many things I admire about you. Your semi-tolerable appearance. The way you don't tag me in YKWD Twitter posts.
I do every week.
The way you get on stage and mumble early female comic premises.
Boo-hoo. Like... Boo to her, not you.
Oh.
I love cats. Oh my God. My pussy is a metaphor.
Are you talking about Lauren?
I admire the way you've quickly made friends with Christy Cello, Maura Merrick. It's like you're slowly winning this town over, one annoying person at a time.
Oh.
I'm just kidding.
Hey, you agree? With just jokes.
Just joking.
Just jokes.
Why are you turning to Tracy Morgan? Just jokes. He's joking. You can joke. I fucked you in the kidney. I didn't really fuck you in the kidney. You can't get me for that. Yo, go ahead, Deepu. Do your thing. I'm doo-doo-doo-pee-boo.
Sometimes I despise you. And then I realize, what am I doing? She runs a show up Stand Up New York.
Oh.
But honestly, I've come to appreciate your presence on the show. Because, you know, what would YKWD be without your occasional tale of how you contracted a disease? It would be 2 minutes shorter. This is my roast battle redemption.
Wow, good for you.
Yeah.
I love you, Deepu.
Anyway.
Well, I wrote a poem for both of you.
You did?
Yeah. Go fuck yourselves. Okay, you're lucky I took you off the streets of Nowhereville. Okay, and let's do good fan, bad fan, and move the fuck on.
All right,
and get this show started. We got a kicker show today. Yeah. We got two of the regulators.
Yeah. All right, are we doing good fan, bad fan
now? Yeah, do it. Do you get the same old thing?
No.
Nice.
Deep inside the Congo jungle, there is good fan, and there is bad fan.
It's too good.
I don't like that they're getting worse but better.
I know.
I don't understand the production value.
I'm learning all the wrong things at the right time.
God damn it, God. What do we got?
Our first good fan emailed you.
Woo.
Emailed you personally, Chad Smith. He says, I just wanted to say I became a premium member a little while ago, and I really dig the fact that all the older shows are available.
Yes, they are.
I've pretty much left...
Over 300.
Yeah. That's right. He says, I've pretty much left other morning radio shows I used to listen to, and just listened to YKWD on my way to work. Keep it up.
Hey, man, I appreciate that. Thank you for becoming a premium member. Mm-hmm. We're getting more and more premium members every day, and you can go to the website... you go to the app store just on your phone. Download the
Robert Kelly's You Know What Dude app.
Robert Kelly's You Know What Dude app. It's free. And there you go. Become a premium member. It's $1.99 a month. And you support the show. You get over 300 of the back episodes. We got Creeps for Kids up. We got another one coming up. We got all these videos. I got one-on-ones up there. There's extra content, but you know, it's you supporting the show.
What a great fan.
Well, a great fan, and I'm glad you like it. But if you don't want to become a premium member, you don't have to. 10 of the shows are always, the latest 10 are always available for nada. Go ahead.
Our first bad fan. Comment about last week's episode by Dimebag Me Too on YouTube.
So he smokes weed.
Probably. He says, this lineup was too fucking Jewy for me. Holy fuck.
Well, who was last week?
Lisa Traeger, Jared Fried, Shuli.
That was Jewy.
And you're kind of like Jewish too. You have that Jewish upbringing.
I am very Jewish. I have some Jewish, you know. Yeah. I have Jew in me. I do.
You have that one Jewish.
I do. Yeah. I have a Ken Lazarus, my foster dad. I worked at a Jewish camp. Yeah. I have Jewish friends. I love B&H photo. I love just going there some days and just hanging out.
Hey.
There he is. Hey. The man, my friend, Dan Soda.
I was going to get so mad if Lewis was up here already.
There he is.
Flatbill Bobby, look at you.
Dan Soda. Why would Lewis be on time?
That's what I was wondering.
Why would Lewis ever be on time?
Because I was early, so I was like...
Do you have little boys hanging with you now?
Yeah, bro.
What, do you have a squad?
Call me the Barry Sobel of 2017.
Sobel! We got Dan Soda's in the house. We're doing good fan, bad fan right now.
Yep.
All right, so let's... We're gonna introduce Dan Soda right now. Hey, Dan Soda.
We got Dan Soda here from Billions, from the show.
Here he is. I mean, look, let's just be real. Dan Soda from the Mexican restaurant. That's what I know him from.
It's called
Guacamole Kid.
50th and 3rd.
The Guacamole Kid.
And please give me my proper title, which is Senior Lunch Closer.
And I remember Dan, you were Soda on the show when you wouldn't even name the restaurant because you in your head was like, I have to go back there, maybe.
There's still...
But now you're a superstar on Billions.
No, I'm a peripheral character, but it's a very fun
show. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah. Oh.
You are a... Hi. Oh, my God. What
so
a sweetie.
Lovely.
Oh, my God. See, that's a proper guest.
Yeah.
Just a proper human being.
A basket of gifts every time.
I don't know. Maybe you would have got me a chocolate dot something. With friends for how long? You're on Billions!
I care about your health.
You make Billions!
I care about your health.
Billions!
When ever in the history of our friendship has it been cool for me to show up on Valentine's Day with a gift for you?
Every lonely Valentine's Day.
I don't like
when I waited for you and you didn't show up.
I don't like Flatbill Bobby. I don't like
Flatbill Bobby.
Quack, quack, quack. Yo, yeah. By the way,
what?
Owner of the Patriots.
Yes.
Robert Kraft.
Yes, I know him.
Was at the Billions premiere last night.
Of course you. Of course your lucky life would have.
I didn't talk to him. I talked to Phil Jackson. Ha!
Fuck Phil Jackson.
Oh, what? That's the greatest.
How are you?
Coach of all time.
I'm good.
You look
good.
Adorable, by the way.
Oh, thanks.
You look like we should be in Amsterdam right now, looking at wooden shoes.
Yes.
Am I okay here?
Is that where she's sitting?
Yeah,
that's where you're sitting, sweetie. Yep.
Rosebud does look strikingly like an exchange student from Sweden.
She does. She looks like she should like ABBA.
I am Swedish.
Remember ABBA?
Me too.
Really?
I'm half Soder.
But you got the tall thing.
I got the Viking blood.
Yeah, well, he got the Viking nose.
Hey, that's actually cool. I'll take that.
There he is. Louis J. Gomez.
Why is he wearing the coat that every homeless guy wears where he exposes himself to women?
Don't bring it up. Don't bring it up.
That's a look at my dick on the train.
It's so cold. I don't care about I don't care about fashion.
Yeah.
That's Luis Gomez when he used to flyer the Stand Up New York.
Remember when he used to carry a knife with him?
Yeah, knife.
You did?
Knives.
Oh, no, you had a knife. You threatened your roommate with a knife.
Where are you sitting? Right over here, buddy.
Got you two coffees. You needed two coffees today.
Yes.
Right. So, what are you going to do? He needs two coffees. I don't like that you fucking order people around.
You tank top?
No, I didn't fucking order anybody around.
Are you wearing a tank top?
Yeah, it came from the gym, bro.
Sleeves, no sleeves. Not a tank top, no sleeves. Can I tell you a story? Not now, of course. The last time I got into shape, I was probably 2 months into getting into shape, and I started, you know, when you start to feel good?
Yeah.
And I cut my sleeves off. That's where I was at, where you couldn't show the side. It couldn't be tight, but I could have my arms out. Walking out, 1:30 at night from the gym over here, there's a tranny bar. Right? Like that. I used to walk by it, you know.
On Chamber Street?
Hope to get lucky. Right? No, right over here.
Christopher? Okay, I'd start throwing out random ones.
That's the name of the tranny, Christopher.
All of a sudden, the tranny leans on one ass, sees me coming, leans on one ass cheek. big ass tranny, and I'm waiting for my compliment. I start smiling. I'm like fucking. I'm like 30 feet away smiling. I'm walking up. She's there like that. I get up close. She goes, "Oh, Bobby, you fat." I still had a smile. I was frozen. I was in shock. I was hurt so bad. I just went, I'm working on it. I just went. Then I went home. I woke my wife up. I'm like, I just got fucking a tranny. She's calling me. I'm doing the best. She's like, it's a guy. Dude, it's a guy.
So, that's a chick with a dick.
Yeah, but that's okay. Because I go to my steam rooms in my gyms, right?
That's how he makes extra money.
Well, no.
They don't call me fat.
85% of the time, the guy works up a boner.
Really?
That there's a gay guy in the steam room, and he gets a boner, and he makes eye contact with me. Yeah. And
what do you do, Go? What do you do?
I flex a little. I give him a show.
Do you do like a cowboy hello? Where you're like, how are you?
Do you pop your helmet out of that uncircumcised Reekin cock you have?
No, you know I have a circumcised cock.
I know, but I say it and you get mad at it. That's why I say it.
So,
this is Flat Bill Bobby. It's a lot of energy.
It's a new thing. This new hat.
He's doing a lot of colleges and wearing flat bills.
Is this really Bobby?
I'm hanging out with J Train.
Oh God. Oh no. What happened to you?
Have you ever done J Train podcast?
I love it.
It's so much fun. Yeah. But it's really hilarious. I was like, Jared, you know, like, I hate these people. Yeah. Like, your fan base, I hate them.
I love this. The show is running.
The show's so great, good. Yeah.
Stay on this thing that you're talking about. I'm sorry. Because it's Valentine's Day, and I want to talk about love. So the guy's getting hard 85% of the time? Do you have an app to calculate this?
If you go to a steam room in a gym in New York City after 8 p.m.
Yes, you will get your cock sucked.
You can?
Or you get jerked off.
And you don't even have to be that good looking, because right now when I'm in a fucking towel, I'm in a towel, right? The towels that they have at like the gyms, they're not
face
big.
Cloths.
Yeah, they're fucking tiny.
I have to tie two together like I'm making a prison escape.
That's what I do.
Oh!
No, well, it was just a good joke without that.
I was celebrating the joke.
No, you know. Don't spike the ball. No flatbill Bobby. Go back to old Bobby. Go old Bobby.
I like flatbill Bobby.
Dude, I can't take flatbill Bobby.
I think flatbill Bobby might actually be able to change lives. No. Old Bobby ain't changing nobody's fucking life.
I'm changing lives.
I'm starting to call him Act Out Bobby.
Why?
No. There's just funny as is.
All right, so you're sucking this guy's cock.
No, I'm not sucking his cock, Bobby.
You want to suck
the towel? Here's the deal, right? Towels at gyms, I can get him to just touch. This is how I'm getting back to gym, because I got it to touch now. Yeah. So I get him to touch, I pinch it, then I take another towel, and I go from the other side, so it's, and I tuck it in around the whole thing. Two towels.
Can I just say
looks
this,
like
though?
One. You don't look like a fat animal, you're tricking everyone into think that one towel fits you.
But strictly from a physics standpoint,
yeah,
yes. One of those towels goes, they both go.
Yes, true.
So, I tell you the time,
there's no grabbing half of one. You're fucking full naked.
I tied my towels together to make one towel, and I bumped into an Adonis, and both our towels fell off, and I was just staring at his cock.
And he goes,
dude, his cock was. His that's where I got the V dick ab.
Yeah.
It was this fucking, it's just this muscle that held his massive arrow. Dick up.
Did you do one of those sitcom bump into where you go, hey, watch where you go, 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 go,
your tongue fell out of your mouth.
I wanted.
We have a caller if you want to take
is this
it.
Yours?
Yeah, we. Oh, whoa. We have a
caller. Caller 954-6.
No, don't do that.
What?
Don't ever do
they
that.
They want friends.
No, they don't.
They're calling because they want friends.
You can get sued, man. You can get sued.
This dude. Asshole on the phone right now, whoever it is,
sued.
They won't sue me.
Buddy.
954.
This is Robert Kraft.
683.
The owner of the Patriots.
Yes, so I talked to him yesterday. He was heading back up to New England.
Oh.
Who is it?
All right, good. Shut up. This is my show.
Dude, you're on with the fucking Bob and the Bill.
He does so many podcasts, he doesn't know when he's not hosting.
Yeah, he goes, is this hammer fisting? What year is this?
You're last, dude.
Has James been born yet?
If you go
I'm
on
talking
Stern,
to you from the future.
If he was on Howard Stern, you go, all right, next caller. Wait.
Yeah.
What do we got? Hello, speak. You're on the YKWD. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm sorry, man. Listen, I wanted to speak to Kevin. I obviously got some sort of wrong number.
Oh, we use the same number as Misery Loves Company, so he's calling for that.
Why do we use? You can so talk great. To Kevin's right here.
That's amazing.
Kevin, what are you doing?
Hey, what's up? I'm jealous of my brother. Hey, what?
Hey, Kevin, I'm sorry, man. Stay here. I'm sorry. I got the number by mistake. It's... Are you on the air now?
No. We're warming up. We're getting ready for a show.
Oh, okay. I just want to call and say hi. You doing all right?
Yeah, man. What's going on?
I'm sorry. I was in the... I came looking for you last night, but I couldn't find you.
So would you...
Are you going to be in town for the whole week?
Would you come look for me?
She's at the cellar.
Oh, yeah. No, yeah. Don't come there anymore. They don't want you okay. there.
Why is that recorded? It's my Kevin and Brett impression.
Are you sure about that?
Yeah, you're a fucking faggot. And I'll punch you in the fucking face if I ever see you again, you fucking bitch.
This is why Lewis can't be prayed for.
All right, listen.
This is why.
Yeah, I'm gonna fuck your wife. You understand?
All right, we gotta go. We gotta
Kevin
go.
Fucking okay. Brennan. I'm Kevin Enjoy fucking Brennan. I'm gonna fuck your wife.
What's
I'm gonna
hang up. Did you hang up?
I hung up.
What's
Rachel,
wrong with you?
You
can't have anything.
What's wrong?
You ruin everything.
Show up at the cellar. Like, did you hear that Kevin Brennan was murdered? What?
I think I started getting into the character. I think I did a pretty good job.
I say something that was a little creepy the way this guy was talking.
He was like, yeah, I was looking for you,
and he was very easily convinced that that was Kevin Brennan.
I started getting the accent down.
No, you did. No, you did not. Buddy, you did a retarded one without a W.
You did a different accent yeah. every time he responded. Did,
you did deaf Kevin Brennan.
Like, I want to go down my
hat. Where were you? Did you not see me?
He and Will Smith had a kid. You were just there.
Yeah. Why are you coming?
Don't come down. Just on mic now.
What?
On mic, pulling up content.
Yeah, he's doing a lot of shit.
Look at me.
I don't know what's happening here.
This sucks.
It's like time traveling on Why Kid IBD. I only get invited every 6 months or so.
You're
so every
a
time
bitch.
I come in,
no.
there's a
oh!
dude.
Such a little bitch.
Oh!
You can't even say anything.
Are you sure you want to talk to me that way?
Yeah, I'll talk to you like that.
You're sure you want to talk to me?
First of all, we all know. It's not a big,
what?
We all know you dumb
you all
threats.
I tell Bobby everything.
We all know.
So fuck yourself.
What's all the threats?
Nobody cares.
Ben doesn't know.
Who cares?
Ben
doesn't know.
What?
Why does everyone know? You
What's
didn't
happening?
I, first off, I just love the conflict.
Yeah.
No. I feel like I'm back.
Lewis!
There's a mic right there, you
oh,
stupid.
Nice. All right. Yeah, who wouldn't? I'd take a ride on that.
Well, she wanted to. She didn't think you were interested.
What?
Did I
what?
Say that?
No,
you
didn't say that.
I'm kidding. Are you?
Is that what your threat? That was the threat?
Yeah, that's
that you're going to reveal that?
Yeah.
I love
that.
Well,
that's a good thing
no,
for her.
She specifically said, don't say it on the show. Mm-hmm. And
I'm
then,
fucking with
so
you.
The
it's
first thing,
everything.
The first thing Lewis does is try to say it on the show. This is why you'll be alone in a few years.
But Lewis,
as soon as Lewis turns 50, everybody's dumping him.
But politically,
yes,
he lost the power by letting it out originally.
Buddy,
you're supposed to just
here's where you take
power. But then she nullified it by telling Bobby.
But she doesn't care.
Yeah,
because
so
it's not like it was Mike. If it was Mike Lawrence, we'd all be like, oh, don't tell anybody.
No, that
you know what I mean?
That yeah. fine piece of that fine piece of knowledge.
Can you please
really
cover
is.
Your Hawaiian shoulders?
Yeah, you really do.
Yeah, you have luau fucking arms. Yeah, take it off, baby. Take it off.
It's making
yeah,
hot.
Feel good.
You really,
yeah, like the shower.
I started
like
doing hot yoga
room.
As well.
Boy, ooh. Yeah, you want to get head more.
You really do have all-inclusive shoulders.
It really does. Mm-hmm.
You look like you work at an all-inclusive resort.
You have...
That's all right. I'm getting a little out of flat.
I gotta like it.
No, here's the problem. Dan never gets a bandana because Bobby Kelly wants to suck your cock.
Yeah. I get
and
bandana
giggles,
all the fucking
he giggles
time.
Like a flirty middle schooler.
You're just mad
every time
you're
you open your
political
mouth.
Thing
every time
work.
You open your fucking mouth.
I've had the bandana so many times.
Bobby giggling.
And I fucking hate it all the time.
His arms, he's like a lesbian that lost weight. That's what his arms look like.
See, I'm giving that nothing because it deserves nothing.
Whoa!
You're not the phony.
No, he's not a phony. Either.
No, you're right. He's a homosexual for you. And he wants to lick your butthole.
Hey,
keep going.
Ask me, truth me. Yes, I want to fuck him. I will fuck him. He's on billions.
Can I just
Are you
this?
Nuts? Yeah. He's a fucking series regular.
I don't know
on a show that has billions.
No, they don't make billions, Bobby.
Dude, that's not true. Everybody on this show makes billions.
We're all
that's
billionaires.
The fucking thing about it.
That show costs $70 billion.
Yeah, I was on thousands.
Yeah. I can retire. One season, I'm done.
They pay extras billions of dollars.
I really want to say something to you, though, because this is weird to me, because I've been in steam rooms before. In New York, it happens a lot. They closed the Crunch steam room over here because guys were just
sucking
and yeah. sucking. It was just crazy.
At what level, though? Real quick.
Is that really why they closed it?
Yeah.
There's too much dick That's, sucking.
Did they yeah, make when a statement?
Well, they had to cut it because people thought there was a brie cheese factory inside yeah. of the Crunch gym. They had it was too much because regular people are going in there just to steam and this guy's just sucking and dicks yeah. out and it's like and they
gotta go before 8 o'clock.
Why don't you just go to a different gym?
No,
know?
No, it's everywhere in your city.
Why would you ruin it for
homosexuals?
It's not everywhere. There's a ladies' gyms.
No, every gym in New York City that has a steam room, 8 o'clock at night.
Even a woman's gym.
No, there's no,
that'd be
such,
funny if
there's
that would,
no such thing as a woman's.
That'd be
gym,
funny if they really took over women's steam rooms too. Ladies, listen, we got there's
get
no
your
room.
Boxes in the box.
There's no room at our steam room.
It's
we got
to
use
slam
your...
and lick some puss. It's 8 p.m.
It's
munch town.
When I lived on 43rd Street in the high rise building, the doorman building, they had a steam. They had a full gym, amazing gym, half basketball court, and they had a steam room. And when I moved in, I was like, this is the greatest shit ever. This is a gym, and it had a thumbprint to get in the thing, 24 hours. Me, Keith, Kevin Hart, we always play basketball at like 2 in the morning at my place. They had the steam room, and I went in one time, and there was just two dudes in there. And I kind of was like, oh, shit, and there wasn't enough room. Thank God I didn't try to squeeze in.
Would have been so, first off, inconsiderate, but also.
But unwillingly would I have fucked up a date.
Yeah.
And they wound up shutting it down. Like, you couldn't use it past 8 o'clock, like he's saying. Yeah. At past 8 o'clock, you couldn't use the steam room because guys.
I get it. I've fucked in saunas before a couple times.
What was his name? Hey, I made the couch laugh. Let's introduce the couch real quick before we get back to the steam room cocksucking.
The couch looks like they also live on a couch.
That was a good one. That was a good one. What's up? What's your name, tall boy?
Sawyer.
What?
Sawyer.
Soder?
Hold the mic, the mic.
My name, yeah. Lewis. But my name is Soder.
Well, you keep the mic near your mouth so we don't have to keep talking.
Do you know microphones work?
Yeah. Oh, Soder. I'd love if this.
You are the worst Soder I've ever met.
Hey, Sawyer. Sawyer, where are you from, buddy?
Byram, New Jersey.
Where the fuck is that?
It's out in the middle of nowhere.
All right, cool. And is this your friend? Is your buddy? Do you know each other?
Yeah.
All right, give the mic to him, Sawyer. What's your name, dude?
I'm Vinny.
Vinny, no Vinny. Shit. You don't look like a Vinny.
I know.
Yeah, you look like a Turk.
Turk.
Yeah, Turk.
Yeah.
Turk's a name.
Yeah,
just
maybe
a Kyle.
Maybe a Colin.
I didn't know Turk was a name.
A Colin, yeah. It's a good name.
Bastion.
Bastion?
Yeah.
Baby. Bastion Booger?
Yeah, not Vinny. Vinny? Are you sure?
Bastion Booger.
Are you Italian?
100%.
Not 100%.
You're Italian?
100%. Buddy.
Nah, you got a mailman in your path.
You're fucking, yeah.
You Trump, are... I'm earning to you, Mrs. DiCarlo.
You're 94% Irish.
There's no way. You know where a pot of gold is with that face.
Yeah, hey, blotchy elbows. Somebody fucking Irishman.
He's like, you think you're 100% Italian? Yeah.
I guarantee your mother doesn't unmix sauce.
Gravy, bro.
Gravy! Oh, maybe we're wrong.
It's not, I'm telling you, it's not the mom that's the problem. It's the father.
Yeah, dude, listen to me, brother. Yeah.
Mom's Italian.
Yeah, you're not fucking full Italian, kid. I'm sorry. Yeah. Look, you have when you smile, your lip goes away. Okay? That doesn't happen with like Italians.
Ask your dad if your mom would disappear for 3 hours every weekend.
I'm sure he does.
Yeah.
That got real.
Wow.
Why did Lewis say it looks like it's a threat?
Because everything's
ask
a threat.
Ask your mother.
Come on.
Ask your father who runs things around here.
Hey, everyone has sex. You want me to eat your pussy now?
I want to go over. Put my mouth on your pussy.
Hey, you want me
to... That's not true.
You want me to... Hey,
I'm very,
go over and suck my dick until it comes juice.
Juice? Back to your steam room escapades.
Yes.
I didn't know that...
Welcome to the show, guys.
Thank you very much.
Oh, yeah. Happy Valentine's Day, too. Will you pass them...
candy?
That's for you. That's
candy, boys.
Candy, boys.
Now take your dicks out.
Hi, I'm Lewis, and these are my sauna boys, Sawyer and Vinny.
We got a new podcast called Sauna Sucking.
Does that mean can I come with fans when I come?
Can you stop wiggling? I don't like the bottle. What happened?
I'm coming back.
Do it again.
I'm on the upswing.
What happened? Dude.
That's a gift.
You look like Rosie O'Donnell. What the fuck are those arms doing?
Lunch lady arms.
Wow, dude. You have Salisbury steak arms.
Bro,
let me see that. No, underneath. Dude, try to make
is
the
that
other.
Flex?
Wow.
It's not that bad.
Dude.
You have like,
come on, let's see your fucking arm.
Dude, I would never do that. I'm not an idiot.
Fucking udders underneath your arms.
Not as bad as that.
Yeah, guaranteed.
I guarantee
it. Darren, fucking take it off.
Yeah. All right.
I'm not going to take it off, but I will roll it up like you because you didn't take it off too, fatso.
Good. Roll it up. Well, but you got to know, it's just fucking sausages stuck out of a bigger piece of sausage.
See. Fucking.
Who you think you're fucking bigger than me, Bob?
Anything wiggling?
Bob.
Is anything wiggling?
There's nothing there. What? It's just a fucking thick roll.
Am I wiggling?
You got Pillsbury Doughboy
when
arms.
You lose, you get louder and angrier. Look at that.
If I'm giggle, giggle. I'm not wiggling.
Look at you wiggling. Dude, what the fuck?
Do it to Bob's.
Do it to Mike. Do it to me.
Lauren, do it to Bob. I'm not doing it to
Bob. Who has better arms?
Fucking do it to me.
Who has better arms? Are you kidding me?
Dude, I'm not. Listen, wiggles.
No.
Dude, Look, underneath my fucking thing, is there any jiggle fat?
You guys look like the first.
Nothing! Fucking nothing! Wacka, wacka, wacka!
God, I hate Flat Bill Bob. You guys both.
I hated him until he did that.
You guys both look like first round contestants in the first UFC. The very first UFC.
Scott Rosa versus human cockfight. Pierre Rivera.
Yeah. Oh, these two men would be doing this in a bar.
It just don't involve.
Scott Rosa. Oh, shit. What the fuck's wrong with you?
Oh, shit.
He just named two dudes. I don't even know if they're real. But
Scott Rosa's real. Pierre Rivera is not. I want to show you guys that I can go real and I can improvise.
Did you just lose too much too fast? Is that what happened?
No.
Rosebud's got a good point.
I'm coming back.
No.
He's got skin bends.
The bags came in.
Yeah, he came up too fast.
Lewis looks like that pool you bought at fucking Kmart for that party, and then 2 weeks later, and we'll just keep going, and I'll fucking drive it into the ground. And then a month later, you fucking go out, and the pool's still not there, but there's rain in it, and you want to empty it, but it's too heavy to lift up, and then you try to lift it up, but the backside is deflated, but the front side isn't, and you try to blow it up, but again, boom!
That's like Lewis.
The wordiest joke in the world, champion.
I mean, but you got those arms, though.
I do have those arms.
You're out of breath from speaking.
No, I added that to the character.
Yeah.
It's Flat Bill Bobby. He's always selling. Wacka, wacka.
Wacka, wacka, wacka. Hey, I really do. Have you ever, now, as women.
Yeah.
Have
speaking
you
ever, for all women?
No, well, when you go to a steam room. When you go to a steam room in a woman's gym or whatever.
Yeah.
They have steam rooms.
Yeah.
Is there any crazy?
No, never.
Never.
There's no boxing.
I don't even look at each other. I'm sure there is, though. I'm sure, like.
No, can I tell you why?
Why?
Because a box in a steam
nobody
room.
Wants to lick sweaty
it's
pussy.
Disgusting.
Yeah, right, exactly. I'm sorry.
Cock,
I stepped on your joke.
No,
I'm so
sorry.
It's
not even a joke. It's just the truth. A cock is out of your body. A little sweat runs down
it.
Who
smells
gives a
like shit?
Shit.
Please.
No.
I think gay sex.
It doesn't smell like shit. It
a
smells
cunt
like piss.
And an asshole in a steam room.
Yeah.
It's the most. I cannot even imagine how bad that would smell.
That's almost like taking an Italian sub and opening it up and leaving it in a hot room.
Yeah.
And then going back, hey, want some of this?
What are you guys?
Or taking, taking
a fucking popsicle and being like, let it melt a little bit. It's a little better.
Yeah, it's a little better. It's nice.
No, what?
Yeah.
Who likes a melted popsicle?
Oh, sorry, billions.
Like, take a shower.
Why is that always your go-to?
Sorry,
now?
Billions. You
do
don't
like unwrapped Christmas presents?
What? You don't like?
You like what
fucking popsicles? Because
you like grown-up puppies?
Because you have
asshole
Haagen-Dazs bars.
Yeah,
that's why.
I do. I just have Haagen-Dazs bar.
He has those real fruit bars that have real pieces of fruit.
Yeah, but these guys are his fruit bar guys. That's why he's here.
They hold them and
I'll keep
them.
Going. I'll fucking wordy this up. And they put the fruit bar in their hands and they make them and they bring them over to Dan and he licks them and he's like, no.
All gelato, you gutter trash.
Oh.
Gelato.
That was.
Is not the same thing.
So
you're
listen.
The same thing.
I think you're right. But.
Yeah.
I think that.
Nobody's eating a pussy.
What, can I say something?
No.
I think you should.
Shut it down. Show's over.
Sorry. See you guys later. I think that. Would it be, why is it somehow, is it more offensive guys in a steam room sucking each other off and doing weird shit than walking in on a few women who are kissing and rubbing each other's vaginas?
More offensive. That's hot.
Would women walk into that
and be offended?
Offended.
I think they'd be offended either way.
No, I don't think I'd be offended.
You wouldn't.
If two girls were eating each other's pussies in a steam room, you would just walk in and go.
I would just say, enjoy.
Yeah, I like the hand up.
Get out of there.
Yeah. I'd let you lick this, but you know what?
Ladies?
It's too hot.
No, I shut it the fuck down. Get your dick out of his mouth right now. I'm trying to enjoy my steam.
Really?
You do it like a cat.
Because it's gross.
Stop screaming. These mics work.
Do you do it like a cat on a counter? You go, hey. Hey, get down. No,
I have a spray bottle.
Me and him keep doing the same joke at the same time. We both have a spray bottle. What does that say about me?
No, can I tell you another reason why? Another reason why it's not as offensive to the ladies.
Because you guys are destined to fuck in a steam room.
I guarantee she won't write that down. Destined to F in a steam room. Go ahead.
Can I tell you another thing?
Please, can you not use those chubby fingers to do it?
There's no splooge that comes out of the ladies unless you're really good.
It's not splooge, it's pee, by the way.
I know.
But listen, any fucking West Coast comic.
There's no splooge that comes out of it. So here's my thing. Yes. When I walk into two dudes sucking each other off, my immediate thing is I don't want to fucking slip and slide through your cum on my way to sit down in the steam room.
Wow. How much
if they were just making out, I wouldn't be that.
Hang on, though. I want to say something. Fucking moron, like he always does, he's not a dumb. Because that is a, that is, that
is not do that.
Wait, you don't think guys are swallowing?
He's not dumb. He's not dumb because
the way you got that out though.
But he always surprises
like
me.
You, were so, you just said that like you were so.
He
cold.
Always surprises me because listen, because he when he
not
says
dumb.
He says
his this, last words on his deathbed
because he shocks my brain because the way he says it, it sounds stupid because he's saying it. Yeah. But then if you break it down, you're like, that's it's actually true. Pretty smart. It's not the fact that you guys are sucking each other off, whatever, or jerking each other. Fine, but at one point, a bunch of kids are gonna shoot out of somebody's cock, yeah. And in a hot, wet, steamy room, it's gonna turn to egg quickly.
Yeah,
you can't see. And now I'm gonna walk out with something on my toenail.
Yeah, in between your toes. The idea of dude jizz in between my toes.
That's not yours.
Are you saying Louis?
Even mine is kind of gross. If you really think about it.
Well, I think it's the worst when you jerk off in the shower. I try to literally finish off in the drain.
No, I never jerk
try
off
to
in the
shoot
shower.
Into the drain.
Specifically?
Can I do a handstand?
You know, I'll tell you why. I'm gonna tell you two things.
Do you bend down?
And I squat down and I kind of whip it in.
I jerk off in toilet bowls sometimes that way.
That's a good place to do it. You should.
You but shoot it into the bowl.
I'm going to tell you why you shouldn't do
you
it.
Get into a deep squat.
You shouldn't do it in the bowl or the shower. It cost me $350. The plumber, the drains, my wife has beautiful black hair, right? Yeah. And, women's
nappy.
Hair. You have a woman's
it's
hair.
A black
it comes
woman
out. No, first of all, they don't take showers with that. They have to take it off. It's a wig.
I thought you were saying black people don't take showers.
No, they take showers. I'm saying black girl wears wigs. But.
They have hair too. Black women have hair.
I know, it was a joke. Listen, so the hair, there's a lot of hair in the drain. I was jerking off. I loved it with the shower. That's why I always get the bench.
What, her hair leg. Or
no.
Jerking off in the
well,
shower?
Well, there's hair and jizz. It
you
goes
just holding a handful of hair. Ah.
Oh, God.
That was a reach, and you got these two broads.
Oh.
All right, and one couch guy, but yep. Barely.
You were just calling Louis J. Gomez Yogi Berra
first
3 minutes
ago. I wasn't
laughing.
That was gross.
Ah, the fucking picnic bear. I love that guy.
No.
So. The guy goes to me and goes, you have to tell your wife to stop pouring bacon grease into the drain. I go, excuse me.
Bobby, you cum bacon grease, you fat fuck.
So I go to Dawn. I go to Dawn, not even thinking. I go, hey, honey, stop pouring the bacon grease or whatever grease down the drain. She goes, I never pour anything down the drain.
Bobby, I put that in a cup for you to drink every morning.
So I fucking, he can't, he just, he got one and then he's got a slowly.
They all left.
No, he did, she didn't, she didn't.
Left.
He went like
they
this.
They all left, it's on camera.
Damn,
it's
Dan,
camera.
Dan. Dan went like
he
this.
He left.
His everyone name's fucking Kirk. Of course he's gonna laugh. They're from Hicksville, USA. He thinks he's Italian. Look at him. The fuck?
Top of the morning, Judy. I'm very Italian.
One mobster did some time on fucking Shitsville. Banged his mom. I'm Italian. He named him Vinny. Are you out of your mind? Listen, here's the deal. And then it immediately hit me like, oh my God, I've jerked off so much in the shower. It turns to egg. When
and
you
it
jerk
turns
off,
into like a hair
it
cum ball
turn into egg.
It turns to egg.
And then
eggs.
Deepu crawls out of your shower.
The jizz when it gets hot in hot water, it turns white like
it
a yolk.
Doesn't scientifically make any sense.
We've all
absolutely
ignored it five times. Everyone's just been like, all right, I'm just gonna let Bobby.
You don't think
we do a whole
eggs.
Episode of cum science?
I'm gonna tell you right now. You
like
when hot water hits jizz. It turns to egg.
Come into a frying pan.
Yeah.
Come into a frying pan.
He's like, this is your cum. This is your cum on eggs.
I wonder, if somebody has come into a frying pan.
Buddy.
I want to see what that looks like.
Yeah, we got to see
that. Save that for Legions of Skanks.
I don't know.
Listen, I want to see that right now.
No, listen.
I'm writing it down for Legions of Skanks. That's amazing. Nobody's fried cum. I'm frying cum and putting it on YouTube.
I love that Lewis thinks writing it down is typing it on his phone.
He literally went to me to write it down.
Don't touch me, Lauren, after you've been touching that other guy.
Hold on. Can you see if somebody has cooked their cum?
Hang on.
In different ways.
Settle down.
No.
Settle down. When cum hits hot water, it turns into egg, right?
I know what you're saying.
Let him answer. Let him answer.
You're an idiot.
Let him answer.
Bobby, you're not explaining it right.
Let him answer.
Here's what he's saying. Right. When you come into water, it turns into like a fucking like an egg drop soupy type thing.
Yes.
It doesn't turn into an egg. You're not explaining that.
I'm saying fucking the yolk. I mean, the...
If you look into cum and water, yes, he's right. It looks like almost like egg drop soup.
It turns white.
But you're saying it turns into an egg.
I'm not saying it turns into an egg. I'm saying it turns into egg, not an egg, not with the shell and the yellow stuff. I'm saying eggy. What do you want? What word?
Somebody tell him he's wrong.
I'm not wrong. You're the only one. You know when you come in a hot shower, when it hits the ground, it turns white. Do you know that, young man?
I think it comes out white.
Hang on. Pick the fucking mic up. Talk in the mic, you tall glass of water. When you come in your, right? And it turns white like an egg.
Yeah.
Right? And what about you, Tony?
It's Vincenzo.
Yeah, it turned it sticky.
It gets sticky like an egg, like white, right?
Yeah, it's an egg.
Yeah. Yeah. So now, how am I fucking wrong? Three against
you're
two,
right.
Two assholes.
You're right. It turns into an egg,
buddy.
Right.
Nothing.
You know what I'm talking about.
Why are you getting mad at me, Flavio?
Because you're not taking a side, neutral Dan.
I'm Swedish Dan. Oh, look, Kevin Brennan's friend's calling again.
Oh, it's another person. Can I do Kevin Brennan?
Okay, good. Hey, what's up?
Hey, what's up? It's Kevin Brennan.
Hello.
Hey, what's going on, man? It's Pete.
Hey, what's up, buddy? How are you doing?
Who is this, Lewis?
No, Lewis is here. Dan's everybody's here. Listen, here's the deal, okay? When you come in a shower with hot water, does it turn eggy?
Listen, Bobby, I love you, and I love Dan. I love Lewis. I'm a tattoo guy that sent you the other one.
Keith. Hey, buddy, what's up, Keith?
Yeah, I love Keith.
Oh, it's Keith Caramello.
He's the best. He's the best.
My buddy. Now, Bobby, I've heard this story three times, bro.
Which one?
There's no fucking way your cum has clogged the drain to the point of plumbers coming.
Buddy.
Does every service guy in West
calling you a liar.
You fucking
cum? He's saying your cum ain't thick, dog.
I'm telling you.
Dribbly thin
you got
cum.
Man said you got that soupy ass cum.
Fucking. Okay, let me respond to Keith. Let me respond to this.
Comes like baby oil.
Let me respond to this fucking tatted cocksucker.
You what?
Listen to me, you fucking fatso.
He's huge.
First of all, he is big.
I'll take it from you. I'll take it from you.
You will take it from me because I'm a fatty. You're going to take it from underneath Lewis's arms. Listen. How are you fat in two places? Listen, Keith.
Yeah, bro, listen.
Shut up. Shut up. You're not explaining nothing. Shut up. Shut up. Shut up. Shut your face. Yeah, and you don't pay the bills, you cocksucker that lives with your mother. Okay? You haven't paid a bill. You're a tattoo artist. You make fucking $8.50 a week. Okay? It takes you 7 months to do one fucking tat, you cunt. Speed it up. I got a waiting list. Get it together! Make a couple hearts in a ship and move on!
I think we just found flat bill
Here's
Bobby.
The deal.
Trigger.
When you now I have pipes. Now, when they, in the 1950s, I'm going to explain this to you because you don't know
cum
the fucking home.
Was a lot thinner.
This cocksucker.
His home was a lot soupier.
This cocksucker has a fucking, has a townhouse in Jersey somewhere next to a lake. Listen.
They started putting additives in the food and thickened up the cum.
It was like, you know, like chicken broth.
All right, listen, characters. I got my pipes are old, okay? I had to replace the inner pipe to make it bigger. It was a small pipe. Now, the jizz, all the hair goes in the drain. There's a fucking...
The inner pipe was that on the invoice? The inner pipe?
Can you tattoo the bomb bandana on your face? Did you hear that? Nothing, fatso. So anyways...
Is that all you got, fatso with billions?
He's got a point. Well, you're leaning heavy on billions this episode.
Not with him.
No, but on me, he said.
Oh, no, you're just saying that because it's on you, you fuck. Listen, hey, fatty, fat fuck.
Whoa,
that's all I got.
Bobby.
Fuck him. I'm going to fucking rip his poster up, too, you cocksucker. Shut the fuck
like
up.
That.
Shut up.
Don't be a bully.
Shut up. You're a bully. You're calling up my show being a cunt. Listen. The fact is, I jizzed in my... Stop saying, ooh, what are you, a fucking shitty crowd? Ooh, ah. Listen, I jizzed in my thing. The hair got fucking cooked in it. After 2 months of coming fucking twice a day in a sink...
Stavros walked out.
Okay? The drain got clogged up.
All right.
So don't fucking question me.
Can I say something? Can I say something? Hold on, Keith.
Shut up, Keith.
Keith, 1 second. Can we acknowledge the way that Deepu tells a joke? Like, he throws a joke out with no confidence. It was fucking unbelievable. He just told the joke that was pretty funny.
That was a good one.
Yeah.
It was a pretty good one.
What was the joke?
I have low self-esteem.
You didn't even fucking see it happen.
Listen to Deepu.
It's crazy.
Have you heard the show?
It's like Scopo moved on and Deepu moved into the role.
Stop it. He's way better. Are you nuts?
Can I tell you why he's way better?
Buddy.
He speaks less.
No, listen, He's way funnier than Scopo. Whoa, but anyways, whoa. Here's
Let's
the thing.
Crazy.
Look at it. He's got a computer, a phone, and a TV in front of him. Scopo didn't even have a fucking piece of paper with a pencil.
But yeah. Scopo had to blink, and that's difficult.
What's the blink?
Scopo was constantly thinking of disappointing his father and having that type of pressure.
Don't fail dad with this one.
Oh, God. Scopo's coming in. I think he's coming. He texted me. He's coming in after the show.
Bobby,
he didn't want to come in on the show.
Is he delivering boxes? Was he
doing? Oh, shit. No. How's he doing? Good?
I don't know. Good. He left my show, too. Scopo left all the good podcasts that he was on to go be in some shitty apartment podcast with his roommates that nobody's ever heard of.
What's the show called?
I don't know. My apartment friends?
Sweet Buddies.
What is it?
You know the
sweet
name.
Sweet Buddies.
Sweet Bodies or Sweet Buddies?
Sweet Buddies.
Sweet Bodies is a better show.
Yeah, sweet Bodies is
Sweet Bodies, just three dudes with hot bodies.
They should do it from a steam room.
It's just about Scopo's ass.
Suck each other's dicks.
Yeah, and every month they have to fucking pay a plumber $350 to clean the drains.
There's no way that's true. No way it's true. You know what? Lewis and I still, you got so angry at Keith, but Lewis and I are still on the truther band of.
I'll call right now. Call my wife.
No, don't call the wife. Call the guy that fixed it.
Call him right now.
Yeah, I want to hear the fucking.
I also want to know how you're
from a licensed plumber.
A licensed plumber.
He's Mexican. How am I going to get
like,
a?
Yeah, see,
how am I going to get a licensed plumber, Keith? What do you want? What is this fucking Law and Order? You want me to make sure? I don't have a licensed plumber. I got a Mexican dude with a truck.
He's an inside job.
Why don't we just Google if cum can like clog a drain?
Rosebud.
Hang on 1 second. He just went on a fucking rambling. What'd you say?
He sounds like his tattoo gun.
I forgot he was still on the line.
Yeah, well, so didn't we.
Hold on. Hair, on the other hand, will clog a drain. Well,
hair with jizz.
Hair jizz combo.
Slow down.
Hair jizz combo.
Hair, on the other hand, will clog a shower drain.
Yes.
Let me read it.
Oh.
Why would you?
Well, hair and jizz is like fiberglass.
That's what I'm saying.
Hold on. Go.
What the fuck is he? What are you, a flip flopper?
Listen.
Don't wiggle your arms like that ever again.
Please don't. Please never wiggle your arms again or I will throw up.
Why? He's going to take off.
Please.
Dude, why you guys don't want to watch Lewis flap away?
Buddy, you need sleeves.
I just came from the gym.
I know, but you need sleeves.
Shut the fuck up.
You need sleeves.
I'm going to
buy you sleeves.
You need a fucking body sleeve.
You need sleeves.
You need a fucking.
You can't subject anybody working out near you to those flaps.
Those arms, it's like your arms need waist trainers. You know what I mean?
he needs the ultimate warrior.
It was
all
right. It was all right.
Yeah, but he needs the ultimate warrior bands.
Yeah.
I love every time Lewis gets a hit, he looks at the other people and goes.
No, I don't. That's not true.
he tries to bully you out of your laugh.
I take a hit better than anybody else in the world.
Yeah, you do. Shut up.
Hair, on the other hand, will clog a shower drain. One of the reasons that it forms a mat on which other things can stick, the end result can be something that is resistant to the flow of water. Semen would contribute to that buildup of residue.
Thank you.
On the hair,
Keith,
but would not cause a problem by itself.
Go fuck yourself,
that's
Keith.
Wow.
Hey, Keith, go fuck yourself.
Oh, wait a minute. This is RobertKelly.com.
Hang on. Keith.
Yeah. My mother's 80.
Keith.
My mother's 80.
Keith.
Did we just hang up when he said his mother's 80?
Right there. Fuck Keith. Cocksucker question, Bob Kelly. I might not have a lot of things, but I got truth and vulnerability.
Solid fucking and doughboy arms that don't move.
Yeah, but they don't move. Unlike your fucking arms.
Do I get that whole thing out?
Something.
What happened? Did you stop learning how to speak ever since you got a fucking TV show?
it was a fucking good period right there. Huh? We're off. I love that Dan's so beautiful though, because he knows when he's got it and when he doesn't.
Oh, I'm watching two gorillas sign to each other right now. I'm just watching fucking the advancements of science.
We can't complete a sentence. Dude,
me and you are gonna be here when we're 60. And Dan's gonna be just walking by, looking up with a fucking beautiful, like all fat, like a limousine and some Gunga Din assistant, a beautiful wife.
I looked at Bobby. Still, to me, the highlight of this episode is Bobby saying that sentence where he goes, "Sometimes he says stuff that's so wrong, it's right." Yeah.
Listen. So yes. So there you go. Jizz. Going back.
Jizz plus
now,
hair.
Let's go back.
Because you had me worried.
I said that. I said hair.
Take me back.
I said her hair. I said her hair. I want to go back to your point originally.
Take me back.
And Keith just fucked somebody's tattoo up. He's so mad. He went in the other room. He's like, that cock.
What are you doing? I didn't see back at the office.
I just made an arrow on your Indian.
Yeah.
Listen, I think your point is right. It's not the fact that guys are, if a girls were like licking each other, there's no mess, there's no nothing. A bunch of guys, if a guy jizzes in a steam room, that's disgusting.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's gross. They're not always swallowing it, you know, they're going to sometimes just spit it on the other dude's chest.
What do you do?
Yeah.
I, that microphone is such a Lawrence face, it was such a natural, she goes, oh.
I love the Lewis one. Oops. Yeah.
Sometimes you want to feel it in your mouth, and then you want to feel it come out of your mouth.
Sometimes
you give a steam room frying pan, where you have your friend lay down, and I go, frying pan.
I really want to have somebody cooked. Has somebody cooked cum?
I saw the saliva bubble. Why don't you do it? Why don't you try it?
Well, I don't want to fucking. Yeah,
what happens? What happens when you cook semen?
If you eat your cum after you come into a frying pan, is that cannibalism?
Oh, or
no.
That egg?
That's not cannibalism in general.
If you fry cum, can you get a good scramby cum?
Yeah, is that an egg white? Can you add onions?
Yeah.
Can you add the Trinity and make a Western omelet?
Yeah.
I don't even think drinking cum is
cannibalism. Hey, can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Who here has eaten cum?
All of us.
Obviously.
I haven't eaten cum.
You've been eating your own cum?
No. Why would I ever eat my own cum?
Never tried.
How am I an idiot?
Not even like a pig. You know
that's what we're talking about.
I'm not talking about fucking.
I thought you meant
what?
Like a lot. I've jerked off one time and
like a main course.
I got hit.
All right. So you never went. Like a sauce?
I don't remember doing
like,
that.
Like Vinny's mom?
I think I caught it.
She goes a bunch of cum recipes on here.
Wait. Cum recipes?
We are making cum food on Legion of Gangs and we're eating it. We're eating each other's cum on the show.
Read some of these.
All right, so we have a couple recipes here. First is for... We have a creamy cum crepes.
I know.
That's just hard to say.
What is it?
Creamy cum crepes.
Creamy cum crepes. Creamy cum crepes. Creamy cum crepes.
That's a good Valentine's Day food.
Creamy cum
crepes. Moti.
Creamy cum crepes. Creamy cum crepes. Creamy cum crepes. Creamy cum crepes.
All right, let's go into this. How do you make it?
The ingredients are 3 eggs, 1 cup of flour, 1 cup of milk, 1/2 teaspoon of salt.
Well, you don't even need eggs, so you just come into water, and then it'll become an egg.
The filling is 1/2 cup of cottage cheese, 2 tablespoons of semen, 1/3 cup of butter.
It's funny if you skip over the semen real quick. You got some family recipes. It's 2 eggs, it's 2 tablespoons of sugar, some brown sugar, 2 tablespoons.
We've all eaten cum in a fast food restaurant. There's no way the amount of food that we've
eaten
publicly.
You have eaten so much cum.
Well, because
you've eaten a little Kim amount of cum out of your stomach pumped. People have came.
No, I'm only shitty to people after I get my food.
When he shits, it's white.
Yeah. He goes, oh,
it's like
ivory. I'm like a sick bird.
There was a captain carved a ship out of one of his booze.
Yeah. I shit bird shit.
Guys, I can't eat Wendy's anymore. I've got the bird shits again. Oh.
All right, so what goes into it?
But you guys imagine, because I remember when
Let him read this. I want to hear what the recipe is.
Whisk together the powdered sugar and melted butter, fold in the cottage cheese and semen, spoon the filling into the crepes and serve right away.
It's not a
you
lot.
You have to fold it in, though, because if it goes in too hot, it's gonna.
You're gonna curl.
Yeah,
what happens when you cook it, though? What happens to semen?
Coming up next is our lovely crepes. Take 2 eggs, whip them into a frenzy. 2 tablespoons of cum.
No, go to YouTube.
Show your child's cum cookbook.
Right there, they have it. Somebody did it. Sperm in a hot frying pan.
Yeah!
Oh, my God.
Humanity!
Get your dicks out now.
Oh, it's a song, dude. It goes in D key. Oh.
Oh,
please,
dude. Does he
off.
Just come? I don't know why I can watch a dude jizz in porn, but watching in this... The
wait, stop.
It's so sad.
That was disgusting.
Make it big.
A full screen.
I have adjusted a certain way. It has to be like this.
Why?
So that... Because we can only show like most of the screen right now for that. Why are we killing the momentum?
Yeah, just play.
Because
yeah.
I want what
but
I want.
But he's going to break it. Dude, you are such an asshole.
Dude, is that weird?
I want one, and I want one now, Daddy.
You are such a fucking...
We watched so much porn, and that bugged me. I don't know why.
I watched there.
Because it was in such a nice cup.
I have
first
no
of all,
idea.
It was really thick.
Of course.
What happened?
It was the glass.
The nice glass.
Looks like contact solution.
Can I show this on YouTube?
That is disgusting. Right, stop showing us.
Fry it up.
Oh, my God.
Hey, Marty.
This is going to prove I'm right.
Hey, Marty, quit fucking around on the grill. I got an 8-top back there.
Look.
Oh, my God.
It turns to egg, you fucking phonies.
Ew.
He's literally cooking it like eggs. That's pretty hilarious.
Wait, does he peel it?
Jizz turns to egg.
Shut the fuck up. This is so gross.
Oh, please.
So nasty.
Please let this.
Happy Valentine.
Let this pull.
Wait, stop. I think I hear screaming.
I want to pull. I just want to pull back and it be a Waffle House.
Daddy, it's Vinny. Daddy, it's Vinny.
Fuck that. I want it to pull back and someone's mad that he's taking this much time. They're like, we needed that order 5 minutes ago.
Oh, see, it just burns. It doesn't even.
Hold on. First of all, they didn't use butter or a nonstick pan. Yeah.
That's definitely.
If they
nonstick.
Would have used one of those like green diamond pans, it would have never stuck. The ones you get like the as seen on TV.
We got it.
You know the ones. Sometimes they're blue and red.
We got it.
Infomercials.
No, but we got it.
You can get them in.
No, we got
CBS.
It.
They
we got
sell
it.
Them sometimes in the as seen on TV section.
Yeah.
All right, well, I think that's it. I think he just came.
Go to the end, you fucking dumb fucking.
Oh, it looks like egg.
Oh, it's delicious,
like
actually.
What does it look like, Dan?
Looks like egg.
I'm sorry, what does it look like, Dan?
It looks it actually
like
looks egg. More like cheese.
So what is, what was I right or
yes,
wrong?
You're right.
You're,
thank
no,
you.
You're not
oh
right,
God,
Dan.
Really
how does it turn into egg?
Right. Thank you.
Fucking,
what did it turn into?
Call me Ron.
Ronnie. That's your new name. I like it. Ron.
That was so fucking gross.
That looks like egg.
Yeah, well, don't look at me. I'm not fucking, that's not what I do with my.
There's also
anybody who juggles is a fucking idiot.
That's not true.
That's
absolutely
not true. There's a lot of
that's
great
really awesome.
And they commit
really
suicide
cool.
early.
Is that true?
That's
that
a fact.
Might be true.
Early
yeah, jugglers always kill themselves
early in the morning.
Yeah,
like 7 a.m.
because they hit
they
around 50
early.
And they realize they learned the stupid thing and it does nothing for them.
You know how cool I look to my son?
How cool?
Very.
Really?
Very.
Yeah.
What does he say? Daddy, do it again?
Well, he calls be his new boyfriend daddy, but he calls me Lewis.
Oh,
he says, Lewis, can you do that thing?
Buddy, is that true?
I'm kidding. Are you fucking kidding me? Do you think I bring it up on a podcast so lightheartedly?
Yes, I absolutely
I mean, that's going to happen, but I just didn't know it happened so quick.
I want to 1,000% say you would bring that up in a podcast in the way you just did right there.
You mean the guy who's going to actually cook jizz on a live podcast?
He goes, first off, why do you think I'd bring up something so hurtful? Anyways, next week on Legion of Skanks, we all drink cum.
Yeah, but
we all have cum shit.
We all have
peanut butter,
we all come French
chocolate.
Toast next week.
You gotta check out the latest episode. We did charcoal facial masks to celebrate Black History Month.
Can I say that's? I don't want to know anything about that on the show. We're both on television. Listen.
Hi, I'm Dan Soder from Showtime's Billions.
Hi, I'm Robert Kelly.
February, and, I'm Luis J. Gomez from Dozens.
All right.
That was so bad. It was good.
Yeah.
Sometimes they fucking swing around the moon fast. Wow, that was a shit one. Dozens. This motherfucker has nickels. Listen, you should, if you're gonna do eat and cum.
I'm not eating cum.
What you should do is
you'll eat cum.
You should mix it with some egg.
That's how funny it is.
And then make French toast.
There's nothing funny about just eating cum.
You
there
should
is
feed it to
funny.
Everyone in the audience.
If you did, if
I fed all the Legion of Skanks my cum though, that's
Lewis,
just hilarious.
Lewis, if you ate cum while you juggled, that's funny to me.
That's kind of funny.
That's so two things at once.
Thank you.
What are you doing for your wife for Valentine's Day, bud?
I'm gonna eat cum in front of her. I didn't do it. I went to the store yesterday with Max. I let Max pick out all the shit. He picked out these stupid thing, this and that, and some
car
candies.
Battery. He's three.
Nonsensical things.
Fucking ice scraper.
Chip clips.
Candles.
Yeah.
Well, no,
I
took him to the store with a bunch of Valentine's stuff.
Victoria's Secret.
It's near
go
my house.
Grab stuff, dude. Dude, go figure it out. You know what your mom likes to wear.
Well, I'll talk about this in a second. Probably shouldn't, but huh?
I like your face when I like this.
Yeah, so we picked out, you know, thing of chocolates, blah, 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 blah. And we went home and happy Valentine's Day, because I knew I wasn't going to see her today because I'm here all day. But she, you know what she did for me? She literally had a book made of me and her, cartoon characters.
Wow.
And, but she wrote it. So it's all, it's like the fucking, it was the best gift ever. And I'm sitting there, it's like a big book. There's like all the things I love about you, and even the, you know, blah, 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 and all the
artwork looks like James and the Giant Peach.
And what are you getting? Sorry, dude.
Getting pussed.
Where
bro.
You going? Don't go anywhere.
No, I was adjusting in my chair.
All right. What are you getting your girl for Valentine's Day?
Dinner and flowers.
Yeah.
Coming in a pan.
What are you getting your
showing her?
We're not doing anything.
You're not?
No.
Why?
Because we just don't do it. We don't do anything. I asked him for flowers. Yeah, I asked him for flowers yesterday. I sent him a text. I was like, hey, will you send flowers to my work? And he was like, oh, yeah, definitely. I wouldn't have thought of that. And I was like, okay, well, never mind.
Who are you dating? Ryan Hamilton?
Seton Smith.
Oh, Seton.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Why wouldn't he think of that? He seems like a nice guy.
He is a nice guy. We just don't even like think about holidays.
It's fucking like, young.
It's stupid. It's all the whole.
It's too much.
Everything. Yeah. The fucking how is there's every holiday has candy associated with it. We're just fucking sheep. We're morons. Okay. If you're celebrating these
all right,
stupid.
Relax,
fucking,
Rogan. We're morons. But nobody's
really
following
is true.
You. Shut up.
I'm telling you right now, the fact that anybody spends extra money on Valentine's Day, you should just go to dinner once in a while.
Look,
go get drinks with somebody. Enjoy each other's company. Who cares?
Because it doesn't feel genuine.
It's when people go out drinking on like Valentine's. Or on New Year's Eve, I'm like, why do you need to have a holiday to get drunk? We're adults. Who gives a fuck?
Yeah.
If you
want
to get drunk one night.
I don't know. Do you agree with that, Dan?
Yeah.
I agree.
Can
with
I have
this.
One of those chocolates?
I think Valentine's Day is garbage.
I don't know.
It is. It's a stupid holiday.
Well, if
garbage.
You don't. All right, then nobody gets chocolate.
No, but I like those chocolates.
I'm doing no sugar, so suck my fucking dick.
Me too. Can I have this one?
Yeah.
All right, which one are you going to take?
Is one of those gone? Oh.
Why are you saying it like there's cum in these chocolates?
No, there is. These are actually new.
Yeah, I actually made them. I ate garbage all day.
Caramel. I got the right one.
I think I got cum.
How long have you been with your girlfriend?
What, 2 months?
2 months?
Two and a half months?
Yeah, that's
nothing.
Well, you're getting her something.
Yeah, I got her flowers.
You got her flowers?
What's flowers?
1-800-FLOWERS?
Yeah.
Using my promo code?
No. Why would I do that?
Piece of shit.
But I'm not going to, I'm not like going crazy.
We had 1-800-FLOWERS on the network. And then Bonnie and Voss trashed them, so they pulled the whole fucking thing.
Did they?
Yeah.
Dude, Big J
like
does
that. That was 2 years ago.
He didn't trash him, but he kind of takes it to a point where he's being sarcastic about the sponsors. And I'm like, Jay, you literally can't do that. They don't fuck around with it. They're paying a lot of money to be on the show.
If that's the case, Dish Network's going to be furious with We are going to hear it from them.
Listen.
Wow, that chocolate was good.
That was really good.
Yeah, you
dude.
Just went to
you
a different
place. You know what I got as a sponsor? I got a tushy, Bob.
I'm sorry, what?
A tushy. Bidet.
Oh, yeah. That's great.
I fucking love it.
I love the bidet.
They sent love you it. A bidet?
Yeah, they sent us free bidets, and they're our sponsor on the show.
Now, did you get them?
Yeah.
You went and you hunted. I love Lewis. We'll just find things that he needs for his apartment, and they'll get him to
Oh, no. Well, we have an ad sales guy that works for our network. Who does ad sales for Rycast?
We have two.
Hello, hi.
We have probably the same guy. We have two guys.
Sir, I'm offering you an opportunity to get at the ground level. A really big project at the ground level. How would you like to sell advertising space on the You Know What Friend podcast? It's very funny. We do not talk sex. We do not talk cum, frying cum. Our last podcast, we talked about cooking cum.
One time we had we jerk off on television. Into yeah. cup.
That's very.
The, wow, your Indian accent is not good.
I'm not Indian.
Wow,
that was not Indian.
What was that?
That was a deaf guy.
Whoa.
So you don't know Papiamento.
Perfect.
I just want to apologize for being in the same room as a voice master as yourself.
That was very specific, and
the way that you just fluidly went into that voice was
Papiamento. So, anyways, back to. Jizz.
Yeah.
Let's get to the real topic here.
Hard hitting issues.
I don't.
Wait, can I ask the ladies, Rose? But how old are you? I think you're older than I think. Because you look very young.
What a
I'm
terrible 32. Sentence to
you're
say 32? To a woman.
Yeah.
No, that's not. That's actually a compliment.
You're probably older than I think you are. 40.
That's not. That's a compliment, is it not?
Hang on.
No, yeah,
you look very, very young.
Yeah,
fucking
is.
Boo. Coconut. Do it, do it, do it!
I want the chocolate.
You couldn't even follow through on that.
I didn't want the chocolate.
I don't like, it's crunchy. I don't like
it. It's coconut.
Did you have to use a trash can?
It's coconut.
There you go.
I have herpes.
Do you really?
No.
I mean, I was touching guardrails all over New York City on my way here.
No, I do have warts.
Do you?
Hey, no.
Oh.
Yes, you do.
But she said like she's going to fuck me someday.
Yeah.
She goes, that changes. She goes, that changes everything.
Everything.
We're in our 30s.
What's that mean?
Nothing. Anyway.
Listen to me.
Question.
Listen to me. You were going to do something to me today.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. I was going to read your astrology chart.
I want it. Now, you do this for a job. Why do you know this?
I know this just because, like, when I was younger, I, like, didn't have a TV, and I started reading all these astrology books.
Okay.
And I just, that's, I, like, learned it like that.
Bobby thought, you were bringing Milky Ways.
I used to, like.
She did bring chocolate. She brought it, but why did you brought a bunch of stuff?
I did. That's I got so a bunch nice of free you. Shit from work. I mean, I would have bought it.
That's so sweet of you. Thank but, you so much.
Yeah.
I mean, it does take it away that it's from work and it's free.
Yeah.
Because you took all the pop
out. I don't know why I said
that. Into a closet before you got
here. I said that.
All right. Well, I guess read the astrology show because I wanted to, but I wanted to ask them about cum.
What?
All right, because we were on cum, and we're
all right. Look, we're not. I want to get off cum, so let's just answer the question. Let's finish cum. We'll finish cum.
Let's finish cum.
What do you say, Dan?
Do you want to get cummed on or no?
What is your final question?
32?
30.
Okay, so you're from my generation. You're a little bit younger though. Okay, so.
X-Gen.
Do you guys?
I love when Lewis gets into his MMA tone. You guys are a little bit, so therefore, if I use big words and sentences, I sound smarter than I actually am.
Generationally. We all agree, yeah. Cum is salty.
Yes. I mean, am I wrong in saying these
words? There has been a curve towards a sweeter, younger cum.
No, that's not MMA Lewis.
Signifying.
That's really accurate.
No, MMA Lewis is like, all right, so girls, let me talk to you about your cum for just one second.
What?
Okay.
What is the thing?
First time you tried cum. Tell me about it right now in detail. That's MMA.
I don't remember the first time I tried it, but I can tell you about like the last time I
no,
tried
no,
it.
No, I back it up. First experience, cum shooting at your face. Okay. No. All right. No. That's not really what I want to know. What I actually want to know is you.
I can't. Will you stop using your hand?
Out.
I can't.
Why
stop,
can't I fucking?
Because I can't stop looking under your arm. It's just wiggling. I think it's somebody else behind you fucking with you.
Like somebody's in the arm underneath. Thing.
it's just a ghost.
So listen. Do you guys feel, is cum like on the face?
It's
like,
I've dodged it before.
No, but I'm saying, is it almost like a very accepted thing? Because I feel, I'm older. I feel Hang weird on, asking
eating,
girl.
Are you eating butter right now?
No, it's nicotine.
Bobby wants some.
It's nicotine.
Oh, okay. I thought butter. She was, it looks like a little butter pack so you get at the Holiday Inn.
Yeah, a little Land O'Lakes and a basket of bread.
Whenever she gets nervous, she has to flop a couple of butter sticks down her
throat.
Sorry, it's better than methadone.
She used to be a fatty.
I just eat Land O'Lakes.
She used to be a fatty. Yeah. Now you have butter.
Now I just have to always be
You need a butter
something.
Pad under your tongue when you get nervous?
Yeah.
All right, so he wants to know.
Is it almost like an accepted thing that a guy's going to pull out and come on your face? Because I feel very weird doing that to women now, but I feel like younger girls are that's just part of the game.
Hey.
When you're younger, I think it's part of the game. When you're older, you're like, okay, this was something we should have agreed on.
Well,
when you're older, yeah, it's like
when you're older,
buying
you
a car.
Say it. You have
you're
to
like,
say, I'm into that. We should have discussed this first.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
All right, now, when's the point where you're like, just put it in my mouth?
When's the point?
Yeah, when you just like, when a guy goes, what do you want? And you go, anywhere you want.
That wasn't a question, though.
No, but it kind
along?
Of is.
Where do you want it? In the toilet bowl. Get away from me.
Yeah, basically.
So you don't like it at all?
No.
I mean, no.
Lauren?
What?
Exactly.
Lauren loves cum. I have firsthand.
That was her nickname in high school. She has a jacket with that written on it.
It's never
with
convenient.
The names of guys she sucked off on the sleeves.
like a starter jacket?
Yeah.
Put it on there. Welcome to the club.
Yeah, she's
got medals like the Marines.
Yeah. She has a cast with all the fucking guys she sucked off.
It's the Admiral, Lauren.
She's decorated.
She gets on a bus. The whole bus goes to attention. What?
She has the Medal of Honor.
She walks back. There's a seat. Nobody's sitting in it. Some asshole with a notepad. All right, listen. Lauren.
Yes, what? I've sucked dick and I've swallowed.
No,
yes.
We wonder how many purple hearts you have for
a
it.
A lot, right?
They're not
a
purple. How many white hearts have you?
A lot.
So you swallowed a lot. So when a guy's going to come, if he goes, where do you want me to put it? Do you say...
Butt, stomach, or I'll swallow.
Whoa.
Wait a minute. Butt.
What the fuck?
What a
no,
great
wait
a minute.
In the butt.
Butt is not even.
No. Okay. No.
I didn't know that was on the table.
I love that she recited it like it's the Boy Scout motto.
No, but she has
like, butt. Butt, stomach, or I'll swallow.
Butt, stomach, or I'll swallow.
March into a storm.
Like, she has a laminated piece of paper
butt,
in her basement.
Butt.
Butt, stomach, or swallow. That's the name of this episode.
Hang on a second. She has a. She has a piece of paper that's folded up for years, and she opens it up, butt, stomach, or swallow.
No, it's like, well, yeah, you're talking about that thing, right?
I was going to say.
Is that what you're talking about?
I was going to say.
You go, you pick a number, and you go, shoot, 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 shoot.
I was going to say,
butt.
Where she just points to it on the sign on the wall, where he's like, what do you want me to finish? She goes, oh.
She has a wheel. She spins.
To butt, it's a butt, policy. Stomach, or, yeah. No, it's like her no shoes, no service. No shirt, no shoes, no service.
Yeah, it's at a front door.
Butt, stomach, I'll swallow. Those are the three rules.
Don't you know the song?
It goes,
boom,
head, shoulders, butt, knees, butt, stomach, or I'll swallow.
Sometimes it goes rogue.
Stomach, or I'll swallow. I'll swallow. In my butt, or my stomach, or my mouth, or I'll swallow. All right, listen.
So it goes rogue. What do you mean?
What goes rogue?
Like a, goes rogue.
Like a
like Star Wars?
A hose with your thumb
when,
over?
When he comes in your eyebrow and then your one of your eyebrows is gone.
Oh, God.
Like the Terminator, like Terminator 1?
Did you get it?
Bobby! I got it.
It took a second.
All right, yes. Listen.
What?
Listen, sweetie.
No, this is weird.
Well, it's not weird. I mean, it's life.
It's life.
I think stomach is the least is the most convenient. Place.
Convenient because you
it's
wipe it right off.
Oh, just pull out and come right on the tummy.
Yeah.
Of course. But no swallow.
But you always try to shoot it up at her chin.
Swallow. I don't like it.
I feel like it's impossible to not hit Lauren's chin.
That's the
I don't like a girl. I don't want a girl to swallow.
Really?
I don't
why?
Because
like
I don't.
Do you make her? Do you make her open her mouth like a dog when he's chewing on something, and you grab the sides? And you go, no, drop it,
drop it.
And then I go like this. I go like this to her next.
You go. Stop it! Stop it! What do you have in your mouth?
I have Justin. Justin Silver comes in. Up.
But I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, I've talked to some girls that
you're
say
wrong.
holding it in their mouth and then spitting it out is worse because you get it like in your teeth and like
no,
really.
You just swallow it.
Just once it's in, just yeah. fucking take it back.
Yeah, like whiskey.
Yeah, you gotta do it like a shot.
Yeah, you're not gonna fucking start swirling around Jaeger.
Some girls do, though. If you watch a porn, it is kind of sexy in a porn with because they don't want to swallow because of the AIDS. So they kind of swish it around in their mouth.
No,
and you
the
think
stomach,
they
swallow. Stomach acids kill the AIDS. I think swishing it around your mouth.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
That's not
yes,
a
it does.
Fact.
Stomach acid kills the AIDS.
I will
swishing in your mouth is worse.
How much you want to make?
$20 right now. $20 right now. Because the reason
stomach acid kills AIDS.
No, because you're fucking
68%
gay.
Bitch.
I know. You've had.
I'm HIV positive.
I know you are. With
no,
that's why you're losing weight in your arms.
Swirling it around in your mouth.
He's got AIDS arms.
He has AIDS.
People get cuts in their mouth. They bite their lip. They bite their tongue.
Gargle cum.
Hey.
They get like gums, like they're.
You get it in your mouth, absolutely, but they
just
don't
swallow
them
straight back. It's
they
you're
don't
not
swallow.
AIDS.
They don't swallow the jizz anymore.
Stomach acid
they
kills AIDS.
They keep it in their mouth and then they spit it back on the dick.
Does stomach acid kill AIDS?
It is a common myth that giving oral sex is low risk due to stomach acids being able to kill the virus. What people tend to
the reason it's
myth.
A common myth is because it's 100% true. Go ahead, anyway. Continue this story.
Oh my God, he talks like I literally start to. I'm like, maybe I'm wrong. I'm like, maybe I'm dumb. Maybe common sense doesn't play into this.
Everyone knows you can't get AIDS
from swallowing gum.
His voice. Your voice.
America.
So grovelly, it sounds like you've like been.
No, he screams
shit.
At you, and you feel like you're on a bus in the projects. He's like, no, okay, I'll sit.
What is
I'll
cum?
Stand.
Cum is a liquid. What breaks down liquids? Acids. Obviously, that liquid gets broken down.
They
by
took acids. A rusty penny and swallowed it, and it came out clean because of the stomach acids.
And then it turns the AIDS into gas, which you burp out.
Yeah, and or you can use to light lighters.
So the only way you can get AIDS from sucking dick is if you swallow and then blow your AIDS burp to a newborn baby's face.
Lewis has been wrong twice on this podcast. Lewis,
you've also been wrong once.
Well, no, not at all.
Yeah, you were.
No, at all.
Flat
hold on, what's
Bill
the count?
Bobby.
What's the count right now?
I haven't been wrong once.
Has he been wrong
twice?
Never.
No. Twice, swear to God. You've been wrong twice. You've been wrong once. You've been wrong,
I'm wrong all the time, dog. That's how I roll.
Billions.
Bro, when I'm on set, I'm wrong all the time.
Doesn't even matter. When I'm sitting on that chair with my name on it.
I don't know. I'm looking over at Damian Lewis. I'm like, bro, am I wrong? He's like, we're all wrong, dog.
Hey, I tell you, I want to say this real quick.
Season one's out now.
Episode one. Season one, I binge watched this fucking show. And I was like, I'm going to watch it. I didn't even know you were really in it.
Yeah.
Okay. All of a sudden, this cocksucker comes in it. You are fucking phenomenal.
Thanks.
Because I don't know it's you. I forgot by the end of the season that it was you. I was just enjoying the character.
Thank you.
And the show is fucking great.
Yeah, this season's really good. If you liked season one, season two's, I mean it when I say it,
because
I am corporate Dan, but I'm also
you're corporate
little,
Dan.
But I'm also a little honest right now.
Here's the deal.
I'm also artist Dan.
Here's the deal with this show. You ready?
And artist Dan says season two's pretty goddamn great.
Here's the deal with the show. Not everybody's bad and not everybody's good.
Except me, I'm good all the time.
But
baby.
This season, you're gonna do some stupid shit.
I get yelled at a lot.
So here's the deal. That show, if you haven't seen Billions, you gotta go fucking check it out.
February 19th on Showtime.
Have you seen him?
Every Sunday. Great.
I just fast forward until I see Dan's head, and then I play, and then I fast forward.
Hey,
Dan, I don't have time to fucking take on a new show in my life.
All right.
Can I want to? You know, I want.
Is gonna, it as good as Game of Thrones?
Yeah.
Nothing's
like
good.
Game of Thrones.
Shut the fuck up, Rosebud.
I go, yeah. It's if money.
If you can't remember the names of the characters, it's not worth watching.
Test me. I know them all.
All right, go ahead. The name of the dragons.
The dragons?
Three of them.
Fuckface, cocksucker, and titty tits.
Titty tits?
Titty tits.
Big feet, fire.
What was the name of her husband?
I got it.
Go ahead.
Khal Drogo.
What was the name?
What was the name of his tribe?
The fucking Dothraki.
All right.
The of,
what was
North.
The name of her Gunga Din, the guy, the
her
guy.
Gunga Din?
Yeah, the guy that was with her.
Is that the N word in Game of Thrones?
Gunga Din, Gunga Din,
what was the name?
Filthy Gunga Dins.
What was the name of the guy who changed faces? A Gunga Din is it's a movie. Well, watch.
It's a deep poo.
Hey, here's the deal. Type it up and then you'll see. Just
Gunga Din.
Pick a do image.
It actually is a really it's an
intern on a podcast.
Dude.
Oh my God.
That's a Gunga Din.
I say.
He's a little manservant.
Yeah.
A Gunga Din.
Daenerys Targaryen.
Yeah. What was the white guy's name?
The white guy.
The white guy that was with her, that was helping her. After he died,
The knight.
Yeah, the knight.
Oh, Gunga Din.
Hey, Lewis, do me a favor, because I forgot my glasses. Can you read? Yeah, you're a good reader.
Oh, give me MMA voice, Lewis.
Oh, shit, time to pay some bills here on the YKW Dude
Don't
Podcast. Bum, bum, bam.
Ping, ping.
Whether you're a bona fide golf aficionado or you just live for the thrill of fantasy sports, you're going to love playing one week fantasy golf at DraftKings.com, where you could win your share of hundreds of thousands of dollars in total prizes. Bananas. DraftKings is the destination for 1 week fantasy sports, and playing 1 week fantasy golf couldn't be any easier. Simply pick six golfers before the tournament tees off Thursday morning. First of all, here's the thing. Golf stinks, right? This is a...
Makes golf... If you don't like golf, some people love golf.
They're idiots.
No, but there's a huge... I'm not a fan of golf.
Idiots.
But you're right. This makes golf...
Gambling makes anything amazing.
Any sport is, but this makes it better. You know why? Because you don't have to be a stat guy.
No.
You can come in, roll in before the game, make a couple bets, and if you win, you win. If you lose,
and then you're
lose.
Going apeshit watching golf, which is nearly impossible to do unless you set stakes for
smartest
yourself.
Smartest thing ever.
Yeah.
DraftKings is...
Me and my sister used to do? We used to gamble on the product on commercials that were going to come back.
I thought you were going to say mom and dad coming home.
we'd be watching commercials, right? And we'd say, all right, well, I bet on candy bar, you bet on movie, right? And whatever would come up first, we would lose our fucking minds. We would be...
I bet you a lollipop mom comes home with a black eye.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, she never came home. That counts.
Draw. Push to tomorrow.
She never...
You pick six golfers before the tournament tees off Thursday morning. Then just sit back and follow the action live. Outscore the competition and get paid, motherfuckers. You'll be hanging on every 300-yard drive and snaking 400-foot putt like you were standing over the ball yourself. And if you enjoy golf, DraftKings has all kinds of sports to showcase your fantasy skills. Baseball, soccer, and even MMA, which is my favorite sport in the world.
Me too.
Remember, tournaments begin Thursday morning, so hurry to DraftKings.com now to get in on the action. Use code KELLY, that's K-E-L-L-Y, and play for free with your first deposit. That's code KELLY to play for free and share hundreds of thousands of dollars in total prizes only at DraftKings.com. Minimum $5 deposit. Eligibility restrictions may apply. See site for details. That's free. That's pretty crazy.
Free. Kelly, Coke Kelly, use it.
Darn it.
And it makes golf any sport because they cover all sports.
Yeah.
I mean, MMA, how great is that?
MMA is already the most exciting sport in the world, and then we're gambling now. Holy shit.
Fucking great. So go there right now, DraftKings.com.
Edge of your seat.
Hey, I want to say this. Two things I want to talk about. I want you to do this thing for me, and then I want to talk about McGregor.
McGregor, his cousin?
No.
Vito McGregor?
They just announced that Mayweather McGregor's on.
No, they
didn't. No, they didn't.
Shut the fuck up.
What?
I know McGregor. No, Mayweather just said it's close.
It's done. He said it's done.
No, shut up.
Creeps with Kids. We're doing another Creeps with Kids March 16th.
I'm on it?
No, you're not. You can be on the next one. You were on the last one, the first one.
I killed it.
Yeah, you did great. Creeps with Kids. It is up now. On ComedyCellar.com. Get your tickets. It's selling quick. The show's amazing. We have Jessica Kirsten. We have Kevin Brennan's on the show. Rich Voss is on the show. Who else? We got one more. Who else is on the show? Can you go to the website real quick?
Big J?
Big J's going to be on the next. He couldn't do it or something like that. I think him and Chris D couldn't do it. Who else on the show?
Verbal Agreements.
Verbal Agreements.
Yeah.
March 16th at the Village Underground. Go to ComedyCellar.com. Creeps with Kids. Ron Bennington and Gail are hosting again.
Awesome.
What a fucking, wasn't that a great show?
Yeah, Ron. And Ron has just been doing stand-up again.
Gee, he's the best.
Fucking, he's a
he's
monster.
The best.
Yeah,
he's, so he's going to fucking, he's a monster. He really is. You got it?
It's you, Voss, Jessica Kirsten, yep. Ron, and Gail Bennington, and Kevin Brennan.
Yep. Is that it? There's one more person.
No, that's it.
That's it? Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, there you go. Great show. March 16th. Get your tickets now. What else? Okay, so we're going to do this thing right now. So what is it? What does this do?
So astrology, it's just like if you want to know what's wrong with you or if you want to know like more about yourself, it's kind of like
with me. I can't put down a carb.
Right.
Or a fucking sugar. I am going, guys, I'm in fucking Troubleville. I can't get back. From September to December, I was nailing it.
Have you gained weight?
Yeah.
Bob, you know already, dude. You've been there. It's a mental state, dude.
I know, but I can't. I'm so stressed out right now. I have so much anxiety. And it's good anxiety. It's good stuff, but it's still anxiety.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's just.
Because so if you keep eating, then you put on layers and layers, and then nothing
can
hurt you.
There's something in my head that I went, you know what? Fuck it. Let's go.
You think he's doing that because he's worried about being hunted?
I think deep down, that's why people get fat.
Rosebud's like,
I'm sorry, what?
It's hibernation season.
Yeah.
You're clearly
earning
enough fat to burn.
You just add on layers, and then nothing can harm you.
Bobby, come end of February, you're
going
to go into your great slumber.
Dude, I shot him in the neck with a crossbow. He's pulling it out.
Yeah.
Listen.
When you crawl out in April, you will be slender.
Listen.
Your body.
Listen, here's why I'm eating. Because I'm stressed. I have anxiety. I have fear. I have doubt. I have insecurity.
That's everything I just said.
Right. And when I eat something and it makes me feel good, it's a reward. And it's also bad. It does two things. Because I'm a fucking creep.
Right.
So I like that it's bad.
Yeah.
Like a hooker or a massage parlor, which I can't do.
You could do a massage parlor. Dawn wouldn't understand a rub and tug.
Buddy, if she did, I'm not talking about it on the show. Okay? I'm not a moron.
Flat Bill Bobby might not play by the rules, but he does have a couple.
I'm serious. I've been so fucking on the edge lately. I've been trying to stay away from people. I feel bad I snapped at Keith, too. I fucking lost my mind on that fucking tubby asshole.
He owes me $100. Tell him.
Does he really?
Yeah, he bet me the Cowboys were going to win the Super Bowl, idiot.
I made a bet, too, with somebody. Who won the Super Bowl this year?
I was talking to my friend Robert Kraft yesterday.
Yeah, fuck off.
He owns a little thing called the New England Patriots.
No shit. You will become best friends with that asshole.
No.
I'll see you in a box.
Nope. I'm a Niner till I die. Yeah, Kyle Shanahan. Cuckoo!
Anyways.
Struck gold. That's my new thing for the 49ers.
I was driving to Boston to do this gig, and I left late at night, the snowstorm day, and I got an hour and a half out. I pulled in to get, I was going to get a chicken sandwich. Just chicken sandwich. That's it. No fries, no nothing.
You're just drinking syrup out of a machine.
Buddy.
So what happened?
Just jacking off, covered in fucking.
I don't even need the sound. It's just a syrup. Turn it on.
Covered in sprinkles, just jacking off. And the machine's going.
It's good, but it's bad.
Dude, I walked in to get a pack of gum.
Dude, there I am. I'm looking to get some sunflower seeds.
I'm the first. A barrel of syrup,
dude. I'm in some syrup. We gotta call. We gotta call.
Listerine breath strips.
Hang on. We gotta call.
I'm chugging nacho cheese.
I gotta put gas in my tank.
I'm mainlining her.
All right, caller. You're on the YKWD. Who's this?
Bobby.
Who's this?
It's your mother.
Did I hear you say you were sorry you snapped at me?
It's Keith again.
Oh, is it Keith?
It was Keith. Yeah,
buddy. I'm sorry, buddy.
You know what's so funny? I thought you meant Keith Robinson. I thought you meant like, ah, oh, God damn it, Bobby. I'm mad you snapped at me, dummy.
You're talking about Keith Sweat.
Keith what?
Keith Sweat. Remember him?
Where is that? Dan Bandana. I can't get it. It's down. You're lucky. I can't. I'm too fat to get the bandana. I'm too fat to get the bandana. It's on the ground. Yeah, I'm sorry, buddy.
Yeah, well, what happened?
I have hold on.
You called him a liar on his own show.
You called me up on my own show and turned on me.
Let's get you worked up.
That's why. You turned on me and you were wrong. And you were wrong. I should get an apology from you, come to think of it.
I actually Googled it, and there's a Harvard study on exactly what we were talking about that says you were wrong.
You're Louis Gomez and me. You're just using the word Harvard, thinking I'm going to go, oh, yeah, this guy really, fucking fuck yourself. You know what? Fuck you and fuck your uncle. You fucking cocksucker. I take it all back, you motherfucker. Fucking cocksucker.
Oh, we had him.
I was fucking right.
We had him in a good place.
Fucking Reese's.
No, Bobby, no.
Don't do it.
Down, drop it.
Bad Bobby.
Drop it.
Drop it.
Thank you.
Here you go.
You wouldn't have tasted it anyway.
This is what happens when you're bad. I have to be bad.
Yeah, Bobby eats him like cum. Just puts it right back into his throat.
It's codependent. Right.
I like Reese's on my asshole, my belly, on my throat. All right, listen. Anyways, I was in the parking lot. I go, okay. I go to get my wallet. I forgot my wallet at my house. It was me in one of those huge rest stop parking lots. I'm in the middle of it in my car, screaming, going, you fucking dumb fuck!
You had nothing.
What the fuck is wrong? It's 11:30, 12 at night. I gotta either drive all the way the fuck home, and then all the way the fuck back. I'm going, why?
Because then you'd have to think about what you were about to do.
So fucking angry. I'm screaming.
What could you do, though? What's the other option?
I called my wife. This is why my wife is the fucking... I call her up. She's like, what's wrong? I go, the fucking wallet. She goes, it's okay. How the fuck is it okay? Why is it okay?
I'm in the middle of snaking cum and hair out of the toilet right now. Give me a few minutes.
I'm going to go look for your wallet after I get past this fucking cum cobra.
I got a twat ranchula coming out of the fucking... So she goes, it's going to be fine. She goes, I'm screaming. I'm literally fucking losing my shit because I'm an asshole. I go, she goes, do you have your phone? Do you have your mobile app on your phone? I go, yes. She goes, you can get gas. She goes, do you have your Apple Pay on your phone, your credit? Yes. Okay. There's certain stores, a lot of stores use Apple Pay. So you can get food that way. She goes, I'm going to call the hotel. You'll be able to check in without your ID. I'll explain it to him. You'll be fine. Go to the hotel. And I was like, okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then I had a 10 hidden in my car, like I always do. And I got that fucking double quarter pounder with cheese.
Because you were stressed
large,
out instead of getting
large
the fucking...
fry. Yeah. And I unsweetened iced tea.
Okay, come on. Go all the way. Get a Coke or a Sprite.
Get some cocaine.
I'm sitting there eating this fucking thing, and I just, I got a stomp. So it's yes.
That's not that bad, though. I mean, I thought you were.
Are you looking at me?
It's not that bad.
Have you seen what I look like before?
I mean, that's what I'm saying. Looking at you, I just figured it would be more.
Did you? You know what's fucked up? Because I'm 2 weeks. I'm 3 weeks back on the diet now, right?
Yeah.
Here's what's fucking me up. You know what they just started doing? Because I love McDonald's. I'll always love McDonald's in a weird way, right? Yeah. And I hate it, but I love it.
No.
They just started. They let you choose the fucking size of the Big Mac.
Yeah, I know.
So you could do a fucking one level Big Mac, two level Big Mac, or three level Big Mac.
And it's no good because on the way home, I stopped again, and that sandwich stinks. Too much.
What? Three?
The three level.
No, I get singles.
Yeah, but it's just
singles. You get fucking.
But you can get a bigger burger now on the Big Mac, and it's too much shit.
Here's what I would do. I get the Mac sauce on a fucking cheeseburger.
No.
I invented this shit years ago, okay?
Eat the mac sauce on the cheeseburger. Gayer?
Yeah, that's so
you.
First off, I just want to say, bathhouse is 86.
Yes.
I'm having just burgers, no bun.
I went and said, hey, why can't I have that sauce on this sauce? Because I love this sauce.
I invented cum crepes in a cottage I was running in Albany.
Do you know the crave cases at White Castle? I invented cum cases.
Did you also know that there's more electrolytes in a tablespoon of cum than in a 32-ounce Gatorade?
Hey, listen.
So I never get dehydrated because I drink just a tablespoon of cum a day.
Wow.
Yeah.
We really left him out there.
Yeah, it's cool.
He should have.
That's why I'm out there with my voices, dog.
Listen.
I'm not alone.
So when I eat this, when I eat like this, I'm fucked. I'm in the mix of this. I'm in the mix. I'm in the depths of this, the grips of this addiction.
You were trying to say
myths? You're looking at me like you're asking if that's astrology related.
I'm saying, how are you going to...
How do the stars change my diet?
No, that's dude.
How does fucking Orion help me?
Dude, Orion's belt doesn't fit. I had to poke a new hole into it.
Dad, the bed doesn't feel, Dad.
Dude, what if you're a little dipper, now you're a big dipper?
I just ate the scorpion, dude. I was hungry. Yeah, yeah.
No, those are just your mistakes. That's all. Right, all.
So let's. I want to get into this. Let's do this. What do you get? What do you got? Do you get cards? You got an app?
No, I don't have cards or anything. I looked up your chart earlier. So like, she gave me the time you were born and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. So I looked up everything. And
okay.
So you're a Libra,
yes,
right? And
yes,
then,
I am.
But your moon, which is like who you are on the inside when no one else is around, that's in Capricorn.
Okay.
Which means that like you're supposed to be disciplined with yourself.
Yeah. I am disciplined.
Oh, he is very.
For what I'm disciplined, but I'm. Oh, here's the thing, I'm an addict.
Yeah.
So I'm disciplined with the job I have to do right now, mm-hmm. and my responsibilities to my family. And to my job.
Yeah, but you're blowing all my stuff that I was going to say.
Nice talking to you. Go ahead.
All right, so.
Maybe I'm psychic.
So basically. Just,
also, it says here in your chart that you're going to run over all my explanations on a podcast. It says you're likely to.
I can't feel my leg.
I wrote it out. So it says you're uppermost.
I hope I die right now and that's not in the chart. And she's wrong.
She's not a tarot.
Me too.
She's
not a
tarot card reader.
Yeah,
you think you're talking to a
future.
Psychic right now? Yeah.
I don't know. I'm just trying to fucking mix things up. Throw things up.
Dude, you got your wanka. You got she knows magic.
I feel bad.
I hate to interject right now, but you got your dark arts confused.
I feel.
She's only doing part of the devil's
work. Bobby's trying to speak to an old loved one that died.
I don't like that you got me revved up with Keith again. I feel bad now again. You got me revved up.
No, he got you revved up.
You did.
Well, he started with you, and then we came in to rub it in as he accepted your apology, rubbing it in you being wrong again.
Yeah.
I'm with you 100%.
He got you all revved
I think it's interesting.
Up.
He called you just to wait for that apology. I think that's probably what pissed you off. You said you were going to apologize, and then he calls up.
He is a
people
two
right. People right, Bob.
Yeah.
Great tattoo artist, though.
So I can't ask.
So
great guy. All right.
What the fuck? You're such a fucking cock fuck.
Yeah, he did this one.
Huh? Let me see.
This one.
That's all right.
It's a nice tattoo.
It's nice.
I mean, I seem better. No, I'm kidding. That's nice. Beautiful. He's beautiful. He does
great.
He's insane. He's an insane artist.
Yeah.
All right. So this is what it says. It says your uppermost...
Cocksucker of a friend. Go ahead.
Your uppermost goal in life, both consciously and unconsciously...
Why are you shaking? Have confidence.
Is... Am I shaking?
No, you're not. I'm kidding.
No, she's getting into her fucking...
Like, it might be the antidepressant.
The moon tears me.
She's turning into Oda Mae Brown right now.
Oh, God, Rosebud. I want to speak to Rosebud.
I want to speak to Bobby's grandmother.
She is no longer here.
Rosebud's dead. She sucks cocks in hell.
Start speaking
Rosebud
in tongues.
Rosebud is gone. Give me Kit Kat.
that hurt my stomach. Oh, both of them. Go ahead.
All right. Your uppermost goal in life is to attain security.
Yep. That's true.
In love, you tend to be very close to your partner, but you're probably you probably find it hard to share her.
Well, as if a queen size bed.
Yeah, I'm not a fucking weirdo like Big J.
Coupled.
This is what it says, though. It says,
"Hey, you want to fuck my girl?"
It says jealousy on your part can make her feel restricted.
Well, that's, can I stop you right there? I've never been a jealous guy. I actually jerk off to cuckold porn, so go figure.
Hey.
But as this last year, I gained weight a little bit, and my wife has been the same since I've known her. She's the same.
Smoking.
You know. And then I did get a little jealous this year. I pulled it all back, though.
Mm-hmm.
But that's the only way you can see your dick.
That's good.
That was not good. That was great.
Yeah, that was good.
That was great. What was good, what
I feel
made
like
it?
I watched like a deep three pointer where I go, huh, went in.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was like this. Yeah. Yeah. I was not really responsible shooting out that deep, but yeah.
Well, sure. his smile on his face. You know, when you can see two of his dead teeth. No, no, no. Go ahead.
Two of his dead teeth. You put work before pleasure. You tend to ignore any emotional needs you have that seem childish or illogical to you.
You're telling me, sister.
Is that true?
What did you say?
It says you put work before pleasure. You tend to ignore emotional needs that you have that seem illogical or childish to you.
Like, give me an example.
So, like, if let's say you have a feeling that comes from something and it doesn't make sense to you yet, like, logically it doesn't make sense, which feelings often don't, you won't express it just because it logically doesn't make sense yet. So a lot of times people will, like, feel something and then they'll just say it, you know?
Yeah.
And you'll hold it back and not say anything, and then it, you know.
Bob, are you crying?
No, I just don't. I'm trying to.
What do you know?
No, I'm trying to understand what you're saying. I can agree with that. I mean, that's not. I mean, yeah.
I feel like it was a lot of words that just confuse you, and you're agreeing only because you want to.
Do
move
you
on.
Understand?
I feel like I'm watching. No idea. I feel like I'm watching an episode of The First 48 where they just trick like a confused black kid into saying he murdered someone.
Something deeper.
No, I was not.
No,
I was not. I was just didn't understand what you just.
Bobby's
said.
Bobby's slowly turning into Brendan Dessy, where they're like, "Did you kill her?" He goes,
"I did. Yeah.
I grabbed her hair.
I just want to go to WrestleMania."
No, you didn't grab her hair. Then I punched her in the face.
No, you killed her. You burned her body in the back.
Yeah.
And then you ate. Her.
I don't know. Did you do that? Are you born on a high moon? He goes, yeah. I don't know.
Then he goes, can I go home now?
I got a six period. I gotta make it by six period.
I got a test. I'm gonna fail.
This is the best show. All right. So it says you have a powerful need to feel worthwhile in the real world, like with material security. And
technology.
Yeah, you're like Bobby. You're like
checks his phone. That's his binky. He's going to his binky.
That's him pretending right now that he doesn't even care, but he cares.
He's going to his binky.
He cares, right? Look how much he cares.
If this was a cloth blanket right now and he was rubbing it, you would see that your analysis is working. This is your binky. This is his binky.
He's trying to show you that his water bottle's hooked up to his phone.
Oh, it's telling me I have to drink. Sorry.
Oh, cool. Is that your sippy cup? You got your sippy cup that goes with your binky?
It's just hooked up to it. You know, it tells me to drink water.
My binky?
Bobby, you know you could just use your thirst, right?
That was not as funny as you gave it. The word thirst pushed it over.
I'm also still laughing that I'm calling it your binky and your sippy cup.
So you're laughing at your stuff?
Yeah, most of the time.
we're all laughing at Dan's stuff, to be honest.
He's really funny.
He's good.
All right, go ahead.
All right. It says that perhaps more than anything you need to be respected by others, like important people, to feel secure.
Starfucker.
No, that's the thing I've worked on in the last few years with my with Alan is that, you know.
Stop it. Why do you like important people?
Well, it's not about, it's not
that.
Yeah,
it's not like Bobby has separate tables at his parties for levels of comedians, you know.
Oh, wait.
First of all, it's like it's broken into thirds. So there's like the low level table. Dan bumped up to the big boy table. Dan will still go to the fucking open micer table and just do FaceTime with him.
Do you know why?
I'm having burgers with Nick DiPaolo and Colin Quinn, baby.
Hey, how did you get to the big boy table?
Bobby Kelly.
No, how did you get there?
Hard work and determination.
Nailing my billions audition.
This is how you got over there. You walked over.
Yeah.
I put tables out and these insecure fucking idiots just sit together.
No. I'll tell you, the one farthest away from when you first come in is the open micer table.
Wait, this is
open micer
thing?
And not they, comic table. So it'll be a mixture of like Bobby's neighbors and then like maybe. Scopo and Deep Blue and Lauren.
This cocksucker wants a round table where everybody's equal.
Then
I don't have enough room.
Then the second table is the table where it's guys like me.
No,
and fucking,
we all sat together.
We didn't.
That is not true. The last party, everybody sat with everybody. The last barbecue.
That's because Schumer wasn't there. There was a real separation when Schumer.
Well,
was there.
But that's not my fault. That's your fault. I don't tell anybody to sit anywhere. I put tables out. You sit where you want.
How fun was swimming?
So fun.
That was a good time until fucking asshole had to make it a competition and then ruined Dolores's flow.
The most fun we had was that competition.
Buddy, you're fucking
at catching the football competition under the water?
Oh no, jumping into the thing in the water.
No. How about fucking a Puerto Rican running naked down my block out of Dolores's backyard?
God damn, was I laughing so hard? That's the hardest.
She's 78.
I don't care. Remember when I had your clothes?
Is this your neighbor? Yeah.
She let us use the pool on my neighbor Dolores, who's like Max's grandmother.
Well, she learned a lesson
I love her, didn't she? I love
her.
Buddy, the other neighbors are home. They see him running out holding his junk.
What were we going to do to you again?
What were we going
to
do?
Me and Jay were going to do something to you and you were
rape
chasing
him?
You.
Yeah.
No, you're going to rape him.
And we had all his clothes, but we were making him run around naked.
They took my clothes. It wasn't my fault. They took my clothes and then I had to run naked.
No, I know.
Laughing you didn't have to run.
Hard. But why don't you change inside, weirdo?
That's what happened. We caught him changing and we took his clothes.
He wouldn't change inside. He wanted to change outside.
He's an outdoor cat.
He's a savage.
He's an outdoor cat.
Yeah, he's a meerkat.
Outdoor cat.
Meer.
Outdoor.
Meer. Meerkat dangles. Okay, so go ahead.
All right, so.
Can you still cat cast and
one
just
second.
All the cat voices?
Ooh. I mean, do you have anything good? I mean, this is.
I
just went to therapy already today. I got to deal with fucking me not being respected.
Yeah, can you
Keith, that cocksucker!
Rosebud.
No, I'm kidding.
Rosebud. Stuff.
Could you prescribe Adderall?
Could I prescribe it as an astrologer?
Yeah.
Sure, yeah.
I actually have Adderall.
I could sell it.
You
do.
Yeah.
No, get the fuck away. Get away. No, you
what
don't.
Is Adderall?
You don't have Adderall.
What is it?
You can't do
it's
it.
For ADD.
I have speed. The better stuff.
What do you have?
I mean, Lauren,
Jesus Christ, you fucking Jersey whore.
The brain.
What do you got? Can I snort it? Hey, can I crush it?
No, Adderall's crazy. The brain drug.
Oh, the new brain drug? You got it?
I got it.
How'd you get it?
What brain drug?
It's, type it up.
The new brain drug.
No, it's, no, I'm serious.
Limitless?
I know. It's a new, it's like they're calling it like the new.
It's close.
It's not close to
Limitless was a fantasy movie.
Buddy.
Is it a,
I'm
is
in
it a,
on it.
Is it
Can
a
you not
drug?
Jump out of the fucking gag on Dan right in the middle of it because you get nervous? Why am I
it's
doing
a lot
this?
Of that? Yeah.
Are you talking about Optimind?
No, it's a
nootropics?
It's a brain drug.
Yeah, there's a lot of them.
Try,
you take
just
it
read
and
a
you
couple
don't know
off.
What
do you want me to do? Read a couple off, fuckface.
Bobby would be the best.
Why do you get to fucking read one and then go, hey, there's a lot of them? I know there's a lot of them. Fucking research
but
it.
But if it's a real brain drug, you would remember the name of it.
True.
Yes,
but no, because he's right. There's a lot of them.
Or you're the worst pharmacist ever.
No, there's a new one that just came out that's like the new miracle fucking.
Is it a real drug or is it just like an herbal supplement?
It's a real drug.
It's a real drug.
Just at the market.
You take it and what it does is it super focuses you. Your brain
but
just...
But do you lose weight?
No, you,
then it's
apparently
not real.
Not, no. No, I don't take it. I don't take it. I don't take it. I have it.
So bring it in.
Yeah. For what?
Cut it up. Snort it. Let's rock and roll, baby. Let's see where this podcast can go.
Grip it, rip it.
What is it?
I was ready to fucking party, bro. Valentine's Day. Let's break some
hearts. You should have seen the way Lauren lit up. It's such a Jersey girl thing.
What?
I mean, Jesus.
What?
I don't know what.
He mentioned having Adderall, and she's went.
Yeah, you both did.
Yeah.
Yeah, you guys. Too.
Like, I have legitimate ADD. I'm going to see a psychiatrist.
So do
what do you want Adderall for?
To lose weight.
I don't actually don't necessarily even want Adderall. I'm seeing a psychiatrist tonight, though.
For what?
All my fucked up shit.
So what are you going to do with it?
What am I going to do with it? If
pills?
I need medication, I'm going to take medication.
What would you take?
I don't want to see Zoloft Lewis.
I do. I just would love to have him on my phone.
Fucking circus bear Lewis.
Him going,
Lewis, are you okay? He's like, I'm an okay ass dude.
I change it from hammer fisting to politely shaking.
I'm no longer the Puerto Rican rattlesnake. I'm the Puerto Rican Gila monster. I move pretty slow, but my bite's still venomous. Jesus, Lewis is going to turn into Eeyore. Nobody
wants
me.
I won't bite you if you don't bother me.
Please just leave me alone.
What if he took a drug and it really did just skyrocket him to fame? And it focused him so much that he just.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Because I have so many projects.
I got a project
right now.
Where the motherfuckers are good. We'd
well,
sell
you
it.
You see, I mean, I legitimately have like issues like paying attention.
Yeah.
Hey, you shadow box inches from my face.
That's how I focus.
Yeah, why would you, when you're writing something with somebody, you can write too?
I do write.
Yeah,
I write a lot.
Not saying that we don't write, but we don't write at the same time.
We don't write at the same time. So
you're punching his head. He just said you're punching his head.
Dan will sit down for 20 minutes, then I'll sit down for 20 minutes, and then we edit each other's shit.
And then
he
sits down and he fucking corrects your spelling. I know, you're smart.
He actually corrects my spelling.
I know, he's smart.
Dan's actually a moron.
I'm pretty dumb.
I'm
all voices.
Dan's very funny, but he is fucking retarded.
Right. And you are smart in grammar and spelling.
I'm okay.
You're pretty good, dude. No. Can I just say this?
This is like Zoloft.
When I, if I take a, if I take, like, if I have
are
to
you
do,
gonna be quieter? Hey,
if I have to do a, like a professional phone call, I'm particularly good.
Put the hang loose down, would you?
I'm saying, bro, if I gotta go surfing, I can surf. Yeah. No, if I have to do like a phone call, like a professional phone call.
Why are you pandemonizing?
I'm very good. Let's all do professional phone calls. Like, if you gotta do, what am I calling for?
What do you mean?
A professional phone call. You want to go head to head with corporate Dan?
I want to see if Dan. I bet you. All right, ready? Here we go. I'm gonna be the business.
And what am I calling for?
What you're calling for. You're calling to, you want to talk to HR, and you want to make sure, you want to give away.
Henry Rollins?
You want to give away tickets to your a show, and you want to give it to the company. And it's a comedy show, but it's a rated R comedy show, so you kind of have to dance around that.
Okay. Is Dan going first, or am I going first?
You're going first.
I want Dan to go first.
Okay, Dan, go first. Well, why don't you flip a coin like the Patriots?
Ooh, who am I speaking with?
He's speaking. You're trying to find the person to talk to. So you're calling the company.
This is heads. Yeah. This is tails.
Yeah. Can you do it?
Call it in the air.
Can you unwrap it and do it in my mouth?
Tails.
All right. You go first.
You want me to go first?
Yes.
All right.
Do you have a ring, idiot?
I'm an idiot because you're
shit.
You
dropped
breaking.
The phone. I would have hung up on him right there. Fucking dumb.
Why don't you get some new equipment, bro?
I got a new equipment in your face.
Bro,
why don't
you have new equipment. This phone call's going terrible.
Why don't you make a donation, billions?
Because, bro, we got equipment to buy at the bonfire. Mondays and Wednesdays, 6 to 8 p.m. on Sirius Satellite
Radio.
Don't
be. All right, we're going to plug it at the end. You guys are just all cunts.
Hi.
Go ahead. Hello.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm well. How are you?
Good. Who am I speaking to?
My name is Michael.
Hey, Michael. What's going on? My name's Dan Soder.
How can I help you, Dan?
Hi, I'm going to be
Dan
in town.
Dan expected him to know who he was.
No, I just said my name's Dan Soder. I just said my full name. So yeah, I'm sorry for my roommate picking up the phone. We have a landline.
Dan, where
is my fucking bong?
Yeah, hold on.
Okay. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, sorry.
Michael, real quick. I'm so sorry about that, Michael.
We need, what do you need?
Michael, listen. I was just calling to let you guys know I'm going to be in the Sacramento area. Dan, February. We're out of toilet paper.
I'm on the phone! When my door is shut, I'm on the phone! You godless fucking heathen!
Okay? Well, if you want me to pick up the phone, maybe you should use all the fucking toilet paper!
Fuck!
Fucking idiot!
God damn, I'm so sorry about that.
Hey, how you doing, Michael? Dan Soder again. MTV2's Guy Code.
Yeah. Listen,
I just wanted to call you. I'm sorry about that. That's an island Mexican, or as we call them in New York, Puerto Ricans.
Yeah, Dan. Listen, I gotta. I think I'm gonna go now.
Oh, totally. And I totally get why you would. But if I could just stop you.
I'm still on the phone. I'm still on the phone, Lord.
Okay. Wait, Dan. Did I call your cell phone?
God damn it!
Dad, I'm trying to order a pizza. What's going on here?
I'll be right out, Louis. Just give me a second.
Okay.
Michael. It's Dan Soder again.
Are you okay?
Yeah,
you
okay? I am so sorry about all that.
Is there anything I can do for you? Again, you sound really distraught.
I am pretty upset right now.
Are you okay? I mean, can I call? Do you want me to call the cops?
I'm just going to be in the Sacramento area.
Yes. Okay.
At the end of February at the punchline.
What can I do?
I have three tickets for you and your friends.
Whatever, Dan. Actually,
it's going to take care of the ticket charge. Yeah, there still is a two-drink minimum.
Put them under Michael Donlin, please. I'll take them all, okay?
Thank you so much, Michael. And again, I really apologize about
that.
I'm
sorry.
And no worries. I'll see you in Sacramento.
Dan, I've been on the phone the whole time.
I've
been on the phone the whole time. I hear you.
I'm done. I got those tickets off.
You got them off. Right at the end, you got them off. That was really good.
Pretty good.
That was wonderful play acting. Beautiful work.
Guns are still going.
I'm a trained actor. That was fantastic.
Now, if I was Lewis, I'd tap out.
What? Do you think I can beat that?
I don't think so.
Pulls his mic out.
That's gone.
That's done. You're done.
That's literally
you're just lost.
The podcasting gods.
You're done.
Listen, that is.
You just unplugged your mic.
Let's walk away from the game. You can't talk into nothing that's nothing.
What? Nothing that's nothing?
He's talking into something that's not connected.
You understand how mad he. You understand how mad he makes you? Yeah. He makes you dumber.
Yeah.
You can't talk to nothing that's nothing.
Oh, nothing is nothing.
That should be the end of YK. You should literally shut the lights off, and that's the last episode
just
ever.
Leave.
It's my fucking microphone going off.
I feel bad about Keith again. Sorry,
shut
Keith.
Up. He's just going to call back.
You want to do some chat?
Let's go to chat real quick. All right. You know what? Yeah, go to chat real quick. Go ahead.
Just a couple of things. Panthers Hockey says the only professional phone calls Lewis makes are to a correctional officer.
It's pretty good.
Why is Lewis's head so much bigger than Deepu's head?
Jacob T. Work says, give it 7 years until Lewis and Bobby are fucking.
Okay. Seven.
Seven. That's, yeah. You have to be in the room to feel this sexual chemistry.
Yeah, seven. I say
7 hours.
Fucking year and a half.
Ooh, all right.
Yeah.
Drew FL says, Lewis's arms have earlobes.
What? That was pretty good.
That was pretty good.
I don't get it.
Lewis's arms have earlobes.
Because
like
under his
lobes.
Fucking arm has an ear.
Oh, got it.
He should have said earlobes. He should have said lobes. Lobes would have been funnier.
I like earlobes.
I like earlobes. I have arm lobes.
Well,
that would have been funnier.
That would have been funnier, I think. But we might have not got it. We were like, lobes? Oh, I get it. But earlobes, I get it. I give him credit on that.
I like earlobes.
Go ahead.
Raul De La Cruz says...
He really is like a flying squirrel.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Raul De La Cruz says, we need to get Joe List in here for the trifecta.
True. We're missing the truth.
We tried to get him in.
He's
but
too
he,
fucking good. He's all out with Louis all the time.
Yeah,
he's all
talking about billions.
He's like, we should talk about, that's private jet flying.
I was going to do a new show, Joe. It was me on a bench with one other person. That's the show. Would you be interested in that?
He's like very avant-garde.
He's like fucking genius, dude. I fucking love you.
I mean, are you on a bench.
He's like, are you mad at me?
Are you mad at me?
No, I'm not mad at you, Joe. Joe, I'm not mad at you.
Louis, are you mad at me? Louis, when you looked away,
why are you being such a Jesus cunt?
Louis.
Fuck, cunt.
Are you doing Lorne Michaels as Louis?
Yeah.
I like it. I don't know Joe.
I don't know Joe.
I'm going to have you open for me.
Wow, I can't believe they don't use any of your characters on Billions.
Nothing.
Straight up fucking soda.
They should just make the whole show you, like...
Tracy Ullman?
Yeah.
Dog.
You're every character on Billions.
What else?
Damian Lewis.
What else you got in there? Anything?
Last one I have is by Sons of Scotland. He says, Bobby, you're addicted to feeling sorry for yourself.
Hey,
ooh.
I think that's a good point.
You need to wake up some Scotland. Bobby, you're feeling tired for yourself.
Try to eat what I eat.
Stop going. You leave your wallet, you go back and you get it, and then you drive home the same night.
Night.
Fucking eating Big Macs.
So good. He's so talented.
Fucking sad. Really can I say something? It's really...
You have a microphone. I allow that. Yeah.
I don't think
I invited you on the show.
I just did that to you 4 minutes
come
ago.
Come on, son of a bitch.
Come on.
What's your point?
Dan funny.
Yes, yes.
But he makes everyone else look not as funny.
That's
we're
not
way
true.
Funnier than we get credit for.
Buddy,
everyone
nobody's thinking that.
Yeah, no
everybody's
thinking.
Having a blast with Dan.
No, we yeah.
Nobody
have Dan
thinks
here
that.
Anymore.
What?
Why?
He's too good.
Stop Dan, it.
Don't listen to him.
Dan, don't listen to him.
Stop it. Lauren's coming over here to stop you because you're hurting me.
Can I have one of those?
Punch Lauren in her fucking, fucking big old chin.
That's not nice. Hey, that's not apologize.
I'll just fucking he just
shut
at
up.
He just looks right in the face and goes, big old chin.
Have you looked at yourself, Vera?
Yeah, but look at my chin.
And you're gonna make fun of my chin. Look at your face.
Lauren,
bald fat
back off.
Mirror.
Listen,
no.
Sweetie, back
I
off.
I know a chin all the time.
All right,
I take
listen.
It. Big old. Chin.
Yeah, she takes
all
it on the chin.
Time.
We know.
Listen,
dude,
it's like a fucking pinata. Just put a blindfold on, just hit her in the chin.
I was read the thing again. I like to hear this.
Was, the guy said that you're addicted to feeling sorry for yourself.
It's so funny that the like other countries like Scotland and Ireland, I would imagine, they're such tough little fucking assholes that the shit that we do bitch about, like I'm literally my problem is that I have too much to eat. I can have whatever
stop.
I want, whenever I want. I really am a little
stop.
Fucking pussy.
I can't stop.
Make a
I
valid point.
Bread. You got to, Bobby, you have
shut
to go.
Up,
you have to flip your mental fucking switch.
Shut up.
You have to flip your mental switch.
I know.
And you know that. You know when you want.
I know.
You know what the feeling is. You know when you actually want to lose weight, what happens?
I lose weight?
You flip it and you go, I'm not eating fucking any
Buddy,
bullshit.
I know.
You're not ready.
No, but that doesn't even deal with the problem.
True.
It I doesn't, think we do. That's like putting a Band-Aid on a broken arm, you know?
YKWD weight loss challenge.
I'm already doing the real ass weight loss challenge. 66-day challenge, baby.
What?
What do you do to do that?
15 pounds.
You're 15 pounds now. Arms that look like earlobes.
That's something that you say when you're laughing and you're falling
Are
asleep.
You turning into a pig?
Bobby, but that's like, dude.
I just imagine a Disney cartoon where Bobby just ate and he's sleeping on a stack of hay. And he goes, earlobes on your arm.
I'm going for a sleep study tomorrow night, by the way.
You are? Really? over?
Yeah, I'm very excited.
What are you doing?
I'm going for a sleep study where you go in to see, you know, sleep apnea and all that, because my sinuses are so fucked up from getting my nose broken when I was a kid so many times that I get these sinus infections.
Just his dad punching him in the face over and over again.
He goes, that's called a fucking Boston cold. It's called a fucking Boston sinus infection.
Kelly Kiss.
You get fucking cold cocked in the face by your fucking step-pop.
His eyes just open up every morning. His step-pop is
Oh, look, it's fucking.
He goes like this. He goes,
allergy season. Time for breakfast.
Good morning.
Fucking Boston allergies.
I love that Lewis can't even do a Boston accent, though.
Fucking cocksucker.
That's not.
What?
That's
fucking.
Right.
What the fuck is it? What is he, Indian?
The beginning of it is really. Hello,
my name is Bobo Kelly. I'm from England and I moved to Boston. And it's a very strange accent that I have now. It's kind of English and it's kind of Boston.
It's the worst. I don't want it to stop, though. It's bad.
I grew up in Birmingham. I grew up in Birmingham, England, and then I moved to Boston.
Lewis sounds like one of those African guys that moves to England and then has the African and British.
Yeah. We call them niggas.
Whoa. Oh,
buddy.
What?
Come on.
What's wrong with you?
Black History Month.
No.
What's wrong with you?
No.
What? Lewis, you know, it was a character. It was a racist British guy who lives in Boston.
Yeah, but we don't listen.
Hello, I hate black people and Indians. They're disgusting creatures.
It's not even a character.
This is why.
They're less than human.
They're not a character.
British Lewis.
I want us all to come back in 20 years and find dumb Lewis in the creek basement, just doing racist characters
with a bunch of chinks.
What's wrong with you?
With chinks and Jews down in the basement. Do you think that's what I should be doing? Just hanging out with chinks and Jews.
Will you stop it? I don't. Your career is fucking. You're lighting it on fire.
James does a documentary called What Happened to My Dad. Yeah. And it's just like a bunch of us. And I'm like, I mean, he just started doing this character.
He's a British guy who lives in Boston.
Yeah.
James, he's racist.
Even Milo's going to be like, the asshole should have shut his face.
Yeah, I don't know.
We both did the wrong British accent. Yeah. What's up? Are you scratching your head or raising your hand?
He's Indian. He's itchy.
He's
Yeah, he just went for that, like, just picking bugs out of his head.
But
you just went for that like he was like a cop. Yeah. Like, what are you doing? All right. What are you doing, buddy?
Hands up, buddy.
I try to pay attention to the Deepu because he has some stuff sometimes.
I try and wave you down like, hey, we got a phone call.
Yeah, I got you. Anyways. All right. Well, thank you for reading. I don't know what you made me feel like shit.
There was good stuff.
What was the good stuff?
I didn't get to it.
Get to it. Go ahead. Stop yelling at me.
You're super powerful. Right. You smell so good.
Yeah.
You bench 300 pounds.
You're
amazing. You have a great podcast.
It says you have a knack for handling a wide variety of tasks at once and a tendency to take on perhaps too much at the same time.
You went positive, then you went negative again.
I know. Okay. But you derive plenty of energy from the things that you do in your work. And your hobbies and the things that you take on, you're a perfectionist.
Yeah, okay. Vinny's yawning.
So you do.
Yeah, he lives in the boondocks. You know how it is to make him yawn?
I can't remember the last time I did one of those.
You find tinfoil exciting.
You wanted the good shit.
Irish people always have their heart rate at 90% capacity.
you wanted the good shit.
Yeah, good shit.
All right, well, stop that makes people gum. Fall asleep.
Okay, no, it doesn't. I want more good shit, like good shit.
Okay, basically, it just says that you're very productive and you're going to do a lot of good work because that's how you value
yourself.
That's
my problem with like this one. I read like the you know, in the newspaper, the fucking
horoscopes,
right? And
you read the newspaper.
I read the witch doctor in the back. The man who brings
I go for my daily checkup.
This is my problem with the newspaper. There's so much words before the cartoons.
The man who tells the future in the back.
You're going to say it's too general, right?
You can make it. That fits everybody here in the right way.
Read my horoscope then.
Read the horoscope today and just pick a random one. It'll fuck you. Can
horoscopes
make it fit your life.
Are different than your than like
same shit. That's all the same shit.
Hey. No, it's not. It's different.
Please put a curse on Lewis.
Reading your chart.
Put one on me, thinner.
Reading your chart basically describes like who you are, like your personality. Yeah. Reading your horoscopes is about like predicting your future, which is up to you ultimately.
Hey, look,
and it's up to you
to make your world so much better.
do you.
This is a made up song?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's to make your world so good. Yeah, it's up to you to make your life so better. Cause it's up to you to make life seem better. Every once in a while, you see a donut on the counter.
No.
Bobby Kelly, you gotta say no. Cause it's up to you to make your life seem better. It's up to you to make it all seem good.
When you see that salad and you wanna say no, no. Take that fork and stick it in and then eat that down ho-ho.
Cause it's up to you to make your life some better. Cause it's up to you.
It's making my skin crawl.
Oh, I love it.
Honestly, it was the best part
carrots
of
with peanut butter. Up to you. You can have some fun snacks while you're at it.
Almonds with lightly salted. Up to you.
Yeah.
That was my favorite.
The Bobby Kelly inspirational video.
Fun diet.
That stinks. That fucking stinks. It's so bad, but so good.
That made my day.
That's going to be in my head later.
I'm going to be singing that to myself tonight.
Shit.
Fuck.
Can somebody that knows music create that song? I know there's a fan that can do that.
All right, here we go.
Here we go.
I want to get into this. Conor McGregor. And
Mayweather.
Conor McGregor.
Now, oh God, please. Why do you? Awful. Why did you?
Purring. Lip,
he tried to make his lip Irish.
Do it again. He's just doing a face.
Conor McGregor.
That's Scottish.
He's
you look
good.
Constipated.
That's Russian.
That's Russian.
Oh, he's a good at fighting.
Pretty good. I like that.
Conor McGregor is good at fighting.
You know, you can do samurai. That's it.
Yeah, you got samurai speed.
Samurai.
old lazy samurai.
Oh. Tie my shoes.
Okay.
Cause it's up to you to make your world seem better. Cause it's up to you to make the world seem bright.
Oh my God. The hands were the best.
All right. So listen, here's the deal. What do you think about this? Do you think it's going to be worthwhile? Do you think it's bullshit? Is it a scam?
I think Conor McGregor will get taken apart.
I have inside information.
Okay, please. I need the inside information.
Destroy Conor McGregor.
Do you know what we're talking about? I want to fill you in. Everybody
and I love Conor McGregor as an MMA fighter.
McGregor won his last fight, right?
Yeah.
Yes, he did.
In won the like lightweight title of
the
world.
He won the second title, yes. No, it was second round knockout. TKO. I know the least. I'm a big fan, but I will say.
That's not true. I think you probably know the second most in the room.
I know the third least.
True.
Second least.
I know the most.
So here's the deal. I think Conor McGregor, if they legitimately fight, if this is not some boxing horseshit, get rich quick fucking scheme, idiot. Right?
They're going to box. They're not going to.
But I know they're going to box. But I'm saying if it's not some fixed horse shit that boxing does sometimes, I think if they go in there and fight, that yes, Mayweather will come in and be fast as shit. But if McGregor hits him with that left, he's going out. He's going the fuck out. Because McGregor, his power in that left hand, it blows anybody away that fucking Mayweather's fought.
Floyd Mayweather's fought in some punchers.
I think punchers
hit him. That you just can't hit him. The way he rolls his shoulder, the way he defends himself.
I stop paying attention for 1 second. Are you saying that Conor McGregor is going to knock out Floyd Mayweather?
I said that
if he hits him with the left.
If he can get him, but he's probably not. He's just going to dance around.
No.
He's going to dance around.
Let me explain to you something, okay?
Well, can you do it not condescending?
Not when you say a ridiculous thing like that.
Well,
ridiculous.
Why?
Ridiculous.
All right, with the hands. Do it one more time.
Ridiculous.
One more hand gesture.
So, listen to me.
Just original. Go original.
Floyd Mayweather
one more time. Just
the best at
I just
doing
want one more time.
Is the,
if we just go ridiculous.
Floyd Mayweather, ridiculous, okay. Is the best boxer in the world ever, okay? Conor McGregor is an unbelievable fighter, but Floyd Mayweather will make Conor McGregor look like he's never boxed before.
Yep.
Conor won't touch him. He won't come close to touching him. Floyd will toy with him. He'll tease him. He'll fuck with him.
Yeah.
Floyd makes people that have boxed their whole lives that are undefeated look like children when they're in there.
Okay.
McGregor has zero chance of beating him in a boxing fight.
Zero.
This is a money play. Simple as this. It's a money play.
Okay.
They're both going to make McGregor's going to make $20-30 million. Floyd's going to make whatever he's going to make.
$100 million.
Here's the deal. I've heard very close to the scene. There's a few things behind the scenes that are going on.
Okay.
Number one, there's a law.
This is MMA Lewis, by the way.
Yeah. There's a law that states that promoters can't block. It's a boxing law. It's like an old school boxing law that promoters can't stop boxers from competing in boxing. I forget the name of the law.
Yeah. This was a couple months ago. They brought this up.
Yeah. They were bringing this up.
Dana said if he wanted to block.
So it would be a problem. So here's the thing. The UFC can either play house or they can get a court injunction for Conor McGregor to go and box him without the UFC playing ball, and then the UFC loses the opportunity to make money.
Right.
My understanding is the UFC is saying, fuck it, we're going to make a cash grab. Why not co-promote this with Floyd Mayweather?
And Conor McGregor has his boxing license in California now.
Yeah, I've heard that this is very real.
Right.
The rumors that are coming out saying that they have a verbal agreement, very real. I'm 90% sure that this fight is going to happen.
And as a boxing fan, Floyd Mayweather clearly was itching to get back in the ring, but he doesn't want to fight a fucking Gennady Golovkin right now and fucking lose that 50 and lose that 50. And he wants to.
So here's the thing. So
it's
you're saying
be an easy win.
So you're saying
he's
that
retired.
Yeah. Can I say this? So you're saying that it's good for Floyd because
it's a win.
If he wins, he's going to win, no problem. And it's good for McGregor because it's another weird Diaz freaky flight.
Yes.
That if he loses, you go back and you still have your title.
He stepped the fuck up.
Right.
He's the baddest motherfucker in the world. He goes and boxes Floyd in his house.
Yeah.
There's no downside.
Either one of those.
So $30 million.
So, all right, stop getting so angry. We're not fighting. Nobody's disagreeing with you.
Yeah, I'm sorry that I'm passionate.
But that's
basically well, you're not passionate. It's scary.
but that's the point. Connor doesn't look like a complete asshole because he's like, listen, I went and fought the best boxer.
But
I had the balls to do that. And Floyd's like, this guy's not going to fucking beat
I'll bet you $25 right now, Conor McGregor, if it happens, knocks Floyd Mayweather.
Done.
I'll bet you, I will
down.
Bet you, literally, you can have my child.
Down.
Down. Knocks him down?
Down.
No.
I
no.
say knocks him out.
Doesn't touch
right.
him.
$25.
$25.
I think he's more likely.
$25. Against your kid.
Yeah. Against my kid.
I get to keep. Now, listen.
He's gosh, more.
Don't have me praying for Conor McGregor
but
now.
Great, but
like, James needs a good life and a brother, man. Come on, Conor.
James.
Connect.
James needs his own room.
Yeah.
Listen.
Let him connect.
You,
James needs a good school.
Right. Conor is more likely.
A backyard.
Conor's more like he has
white
both.
Parents.
His both. Conor is more likely to not connect with a single punch than he is to knock him down. He's more likely to literally. I'm more convinced that if you said either he's going to knock him down or he's not going to connect with a single punch,
you said
I would bet single punch.
Floyd Mayweather's the greatest defensive fighter of all time.
Yeah, are you crazy?
The greatest.
I watched Nate Diaz drop two fucking hands straight down the middle on Conor and knock him down. Are you crazy?
Like yeah. Floyd's literally probably going to be able to be like, I'm going to bet on myself of when I'm going to knock him out.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. We made the bet.
Yeah.
So you can scream at me all you want.
I'm not screaming. I'm just
I want my
sternly.
Money. I want my money
fight's
when
not over, bro.
When that little motherfucker's on the canvas looking up.
Conor's also
when
a lot bigger.
When that fucking
people don't know that
a lot bigger.
A lot bigger than
a lot bigger. A lot bigger. He's
lots
gonna go
lower,
in there,
a lot less
he,
technically.
And when he fucking forget with that fucking left and it hits the button.
Conor's
he's
also
go
not
out.
He's not a master boxer. Conor's a master kickboxer. Conor's got his
here's
kicks,
my problem.
His kicks and his unorthodox striking
here's
is what's
problem.
Impressive. You're gonna get in there with an orthodox boxer.
Nice.
The best in the world. I mean it's crazy.
Here's my problem though. If he does hit him, knocks him down, I'm worried that Conor's gonna follow him to the canvas and just that elbow on his forehead. I don't know how you're gonna stop that instinctual MMA
what
fight
if,
in you.
What
you know?
If Conor comes out in boxes like this, the old kind of
like
Irish?
Steve Burns his logo?
Yeah.
That's his logo.
Is this a stupid question? If
yes.
Yeah. So if Amy, not Amy, what's her name? Ronda Rousey. When Ronda Rousey fought Holly
Holm.
Was that like a similar matchup?
It was a boxer. Yeah.
It was a boxer.
That's not
against
a terrible
match. No.
Well, here's the deal. Holly, it's a little different, right? Holly was the most decorated female boxer to ever move over to MMA, but she moved over to MMA. Also started with kickboxing.
She started
has a martial
kickboxing.
Arts background.
Kickboxing.
Has been training MMA at a high level, wrestling, jiu-jitsu.
Yeah.
Connor's going to move over to boxing. boxing, which if you understand anything about fighting, boxing is just one aspect of what MMA is.
Yeah.
So Conor is a very good boxer.
But most MMA guys aren't as high level as most boxers.
Well, because you spend your whole life doing that.
Doing that right. One thing. Yeah. These guys, I mean, boxing is a whole different thing.
Yeah.
These guys are learning parts of boxing along with jiu-jitsu and Muay Thai and wrestling. There's so much that goes into that. And they can't just do it. But I understand that, but I still think McGregor, he goes in big.
You know
big,
what you're doing?
He goes in big, and I think that if he gets a shot.
You do what I do, right? You make these outlandish predictions.
Mediocre sets?
Here's too real. No, you make these outlandish predictions, and then you when it doesn't come true, be like, yeah, of course, it didn't come true. But then when it does come true, you look like you're this fucking genius.
Dude,
you,
I fucking knew it, dude.
Dude, Tom Brady's going to win 5, dude.
Right there.
Dude, they're down 28-3, but they're going to come back, dude.
Absolutely.
Dude, they're going to come back, dude. Trust me, dude.
You know what I wanted
you
to do?
You don't know fucking T-Bird like I know T-Bird.
Dude, I wanted to call you. I was with my cousins, and I'm so mad I didn't, but I wanted to call you and curse you the way you cursed me when the fucking Niners were in the Super Bowl.
Well, let me tell you something. It would have fucking flipped back on you, and I would have went, Hundabadam,
no, that's not a thing, because we got Kyle Shanahan and John Lynch.
Dude, you guys ain't winning shit stinks. Forever.
Shut up.
But your team stinks, dude.
Yeah. Shut
it
up.
Does. They stink.
Shut up. I have to leave and you're making me upset.
All right, let's go. Let's wrap this up.
Are we
this
done?
We're done. This has been a very funny podcast, as usual.
I love you, Bobby.
I love you guys, man.
Rosebud, I believe in your moon predictions.
Thanks a lot.
I don't know if I believe in them. Like, I don't know where they come from.
It's not like a belief. It's just for fun.
Yeah, it's fun. I like it. Yeah. And I think that everybody's right. I think the guy from Scotland had a good point. I think I should... stop stuffing food in my face and being a little puss whacker, which I'm going to soon. Thank you for taking that Reese's out of my hand.
You're welcome.
Dan and Lewis. And
anytime, dog.
Colin.
Anytime, dog.
What's up, dude? Yeah, I'm all right. That'd be funny if I just had a stroke.
he just dies in his chair.
Yeah, I just die in my chair.
Bobby. Oh, God, Bobby.
Please take a photo. Somebody.
No, that's the end.
I want you to take a photo and then sell it to TMZ and give the money to my wife.
True.
All
right, let's wrap this up.
You gave yourself stroke mouth.
Happy Valentine's Day to all you fans
happy
out
Valentine's
there.
Day.
Let's go to you.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, I'm breaking the mic.
Yeah, well, everybody snapped the mic out tonight. They're all holding them. What are you guys, fucking Giannis Pappas?
No, this is broken, and every time I put it in, it falls.
I really do. I've been snapping on people lately. Giannis Pappas sent me a text message. I was just in a shit mood. I had just eaten shitty. I was fucking on the road, like, fuck me, away from my... I was on the road for like a week and a half, a little too long, a couple weeks ago. And he sent me a thing. He goes, dude, your chubby fingers, like, say you, like, busting my, your fat, chubby fingers, make sure you, and I just wrote back, you're bald. You're balding. No, I wrote back, you're going bald. And that's it. And then he wrote, no. And I just kept writing, you're going bald. And then he sent me a photo. Fuck you, I'm not going bald. I might be getting ugly, but I'm... And then I zoomed in on the bald spot, and then I put arrows to it. I go, we see you. It was just too much.
I think you've been your most calm lately.
I've been calm with you.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, you guys are fucking
killing
it.
I never call you because I'm too scared to hear the wrath of Bob.
But you've been killing it. Yeah, you know, you're not a fucking dickhead anymore. So you're doing great.
That's true.
Yeah, I love Scopo, but I don't have to deal with him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Scopo, did you do this? What? He'd always go, huh? He'd always say, like, I love Scopo because he'd always pretend like he didn't hear you.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's the problem, his ears.
Huh? Huh?
Did you pick up things?
Huh?
Did you pick up the things I asked you? And I would scream, like, did you pick up the...
What?
The flyer. I told you to make the flyers.
I didn't know you wanted...
I told you I wanted them today.
Okay.
Okay, what?
I'll go to them. Stop yelling.
Why are you the victim? I'm the fuck...
I don't know. Stop yelling at me.
Oh, my God.
When you replayed it, I realized you're wrong.
Why?
Poor Scopo.
Poor Scopo.
I go, can I just say this? I went into the character and I fell for him. And I think you're wrong.
Yeah, I really am.
Let's start a Kickstarter.
That is my thing this year. I'm going to work on my temper.
No, you've been great.
I haven't had it with my kid or my wife in a long time, which is good. But it is coming out in traffic. And with a couple friends. So there you go.
Yeah.
Well, what else you got?
Okay, so Tuesday, February 21st.
Hang on, let me...
I've got Roastmasters.
Okay. Oh, you are?
Yeah.
Great.
And you can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Rosebud Baker. And thanks for letting me go first so I didn't sound just pathetic next to these guys.
Yeah, she killed Scopo in the roast battle.
I heard.
I did. Yeah. Did you hear that?
I did hear that.
Yeah.
Does that shock you?
No.
No, I check out the roast battles. You know, I guess just lost, right?
Yeah, Zach just lost the title.
To that, he was pretty funny.
Yeah, Eli's a murderer.
Yeah, that's right. And then he called out L.A.
Yeah, we're doing. I'll do it when I do my plugs.
I'll do your plugs.
You gotta be careful. Plugs. All right, we'll do it. All right, go ahead. What do you got?
I will be in Sacramento.
Besides everything,
I'll be in Sacramento at the end of the month. I'm having a website built. It's almost done. DanSutter.com, and then Billions February 19th on Showtime, and then every Sunday at 9 and Bonfire Comedy Central Radio Series XM 95 Mondays
great,
and Wednesdays.
Great show, you and Jay. Unbelievable show you guys have on XM.
That's all right.
And I gotta pee. But Billions, God, man, I can't wait.
This season's good.
I can't Real wait. Good. I wish I could get the you know, I wish I had a connection.
I don't have one. I can't even see him yet. So wait in line, Bobby.
First of all, that's bullshit.
No, I swear to God, I've only seen one episode.
You can go. You could get it if you wanted to. They'll give you the passcode to the website. You know that.
No, I don't, but I'm going to try that.
Yeah, you just go, hey, I want to see the episodes. And they'll go, yeah, they send you a link to a page, Showtime page, and you type in a username and a password, and you watch them all.
Okay.
Yeah, you can see all your, you're supposed to. You're supposed to have that.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Nice talking. Well, give me the shit then. No, you can't, because they know when you sign in from somewhere else. All right, congratulations for all that shit, man. I can't wait to see the season. And you're looking good, dude.
Thanks, Bobby.
And your photo you put up the other day, you're actually a good-looking kid.
Thank you. From when I was
when you're a little
senior
teenager.
My senior photo?
You're looking good.
Everybody has to do that in Colorado. It's all nature.
I know, man. I hope you go bald. what's up, man?
son. Roastmasters every other Tuesday. Rosebuds on the next one. But the one after that is going to be crazy because we did call out L.A., and they're sending out three of their best.
Who?
I don't want to announce the names until I have the flyer. So they're sending out the three best.
We're putting up. I know one person.
I know a lot of them. I know the whole thing. So we're doing 3 versus 3, all 3 rounders.
I'm very disappointed I wasn't asked to do that.
What? The
LA one.
LA versus New York?
Yeah.
We had a fucking, Rosebud, you're great. You're great, Rosebud. You're doing a main event coming up, right?
Yeah.
So that's it. We'll see what's up. So, but they're flying out.
Are they funny?
Yeah, they're fucking great, the guys.
The ones that are coming out.
The ones that are coming out are the best.
Do we know them?
Yeah, they've all been on the TV.
Who's flying them out?
Moses and Ross. Jeff Ross are flying them out.
Are they filming this?
We're filming it for Gas Digital. For Gas Digital. We always film them.
At the stand.
Yep. You want to judge?
I might if I'm Italian. Yeah,
Marcy, dude, it's going to be crazy.
Hey,
dude.
Can I say something on the video?
Yeah.
You got to light up the judges' faces.
Can I tell you the problem? When we do too much light, it's distracting to the crowd.
I know, but why do you ask so many questions? Can I tell you? Yes, just you can tell me. You don't have to ask permission.
You do the same exact thing. I mean, nonstop. I you say, can I say something? Nonstop.
Let me tell you something.
Can I tell you something?
I don't ask. I say, let me tell you something.
Listen.
No, you listen.
We fucking suck.
Buddy.
It's distracting to the live crowd when there's too much lighting.
Who gives a fuck?
It's about the people killing in the audience. Who gives a fuck if you can see the fat judges' faces?
If you just took a little light and put
We're working on it.
If you put a little light under the judge's face.
We're working on it.
All right, please. Please, you figure it out.
We're working on it.
They have these little lights. I have them right here. These little lights, right? You put them on the table. You push a button, and it goes.
That's
up.
What we have now.
You should get bigger ones.
All right. So, Bob, come out and do that. March 7th, New York versus LA.
I'll try if I'm around.
Also, if you guys are listening live in the chat, if you're in New York tomorrow night, Legion of Skanks, we got a big fucking show planned.
You got a fry cum sandwich.
Jay's out. We might fry our cum, but it's me and Dave. Plus, we got Mickey Gall, UFC fighter. We got Mark Norman. And
who
we got
is
Nick
it?
Mullen. Mickey
you and
Gall.
Who? Who's on the show?
Me, you, Dave, Mickey Gall.
Dave who?
Smith.
Oh, okay.
From Part of the Problem?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm a big fan.
I like Dave. Dave's a fucking great guy.
He's a really, really
smart. Smart. Dave's a good guy. He's good.
Huge,
smart.
Huge hog.
Does he got a big hug?
Yeah.
Does he have a big hug?
He does have a big hug.
Does he really?
He really does.
Like how big? Like this big?
I think I'm the only person that would know that in this room.
How big
you
is
You guys are
Dave?
Close.
Have you seen his hug?
No.
Oh, that's weird. So anyway,
Dave's very smart.
He's very smart and very, he's a good guy.
Good guy. Big hog.
Big old hog.
Looks yeah, great funny. Shaven.
Fucking.
Yeah, won't shut the fuck up, though.
He got shitty toenails, though.
God, man, join the club.
Ew. You ever seen his toenails? They're ridiculous. He's got Nosferatu feet.
He doesn't cut the fucking toenails?
Yeah, it's fucking disgusting.
Here's your deal.
He has the feet Dave? That Hitler would try to convince you that Jews had.
Jesus. Here's the deal. You got to tell him to shut the fuck up.
He yaps.
He yaps.
Yeah.
I mean, dude, I remember doing your podcast. Remember, yeah. I was like, just shut the fuck
That's
up.
That's back in the day. He's gotten really good, actually, as a broadcaster. So
I really like Dave. Really good
Yeah, check that out, guys. I'll be in Boston in March. I'm posting that date because I got to confirm the venue, but I'm posting it on Friday. And yeah, we'll be out Moon Tower as well in Austin, Texas this April.
Are you going to Moon Tower?
No, I'm not. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you are.
I have a notes call. Yeah, I'm going to be at Moon Tower. I had a notes call that I'm like trying. Like
You
like,
can go, Dan.
No, I can't.
Why?
They just told me I'm too late for it.
No way.
Yes.
Why didn't you leave?
Because I'm here.
I hope he gets fired. Why did you I hope they fucking CGI a different actor.
Hey, what is it? The whole season. A notes call for what?
My Comedy Central pilot. With the producer.
With the one with...
The producer called
with,
me three times while I was on this podcast.
With...
Michelle Wolfe.
The one I'm...
Yeah, I mean, we got to roll.
The one that's getting in the way of us finishing our project.
Yeah, the one I'm trying to finish this week.
The one that's
made my life
a living hell.
I was supposed to...
Yeah, you were gone.
But I fucking... Am I not in this?
Yeah, you are. But I don't know if the thing's going to get fucking made.
Bobby's in it and I'm not in it.
Oh, God. No, you're not. You're
actually can sell used cars.
Buddy, I'm an actor.
I'm an actor, too.
You're not an actor.
I can act like a used car salesman right now.
Go ahead, do it.
Hey, what's going on, man? What are you interested in?
I'm interested in a better salesman. That's what I want.
Hey, Chubby, you want some chocolate? You're interested in a car? I'm telling sell Bobby.
Just threw it at the computer, you dickhead. All right, sorry, dude.
Oh, that's all right. We're good now.
Hey, buddy. Listen, know your role.
I know my role.
All right, what do I got, Deepu?
I didn't finish my plugs.
We got your dates on the 18th.
Do you have more plugs?
What else plugs do you have?
Buddy, you can't have... You can't...
Real Ass Podcast, Legion of Skanks, Countdown, SiriusXM, Rush Night.
Oh, God. God. It's the worst. I mean, it was funny 2 years ago. Go ahead. How can you have that many plugs and be the least famous in the room?
Almost everyone except for you.
Soon
to be Rosebud.
Depends on how much money she does in the backing of the moon reading, because that could get huge.
So closing live, Bobby will be at Cherokee Casino, Kuala Ballroom, West Solon Springs, Oklahoma on the 18th.
Yeah, that's this Saturday with Stavi, baby.
Yeah.
On the March 2nd through the 4th, Bobby will be at the Comedy Club on State in Madison, Wisconsin.
Best. One of my favorite clubs in the world.
The best.
Love it. Oh,
sorry.
Tornado Room, too. You get to go have a fucking steak.
Ribeye. But you got to go earlier. They don't bring it out.
Yeah.
This mic.
What?
It stinks.
What
it
stinks?
It's been stinking the whole fucking time I've been trying to hold it in.
Really? Why don't you say something?
It smells, it's just, ugh.
Who was there? Take the thing off.
I don't want to touch it. Really?
Take it off.
I don't want to touch it.
Did you spray the mics?
I Febreze them every week.
Did you Febreze them before the show?
You see how it's darker on the top?
Oh, that's pretty bad.
Oh. All right, Dan, we all have to smell it. Dan, go next. Dan, go next. I'll go last.
That's what it smells
like.
That's
rough.
That's what it smells like.
Let me see.
You walk into people eating pussy in a steam room, that's what it smells like.
Kind of minty. I don't know.
Let me see.
Mint. What's wrong with you? You keep sniffing it.
You ever fucking have Indian food? This is five of his dishes.
Oh, God. You Bobby with the two fingers.
I can't smell anything. But my deviated septum. I have a sleep study tomorrow night. Go ahead. What else do I got?
On March 31st, you'll be at Bananas in Hasbrouck Heights, New Jersey. Oh, as well as April 1st for that.
Right.
And one more. We get on April 6th, 7th, and 8th, you'll be at Comics Mohegan Sun in Uncasville, Connecticut.
Yeah, great club. Great club. I can't wait. I got a lot of great gigs coming up in the next 4 weeks. I'm going to Aruba. If you guys are down in Aruba, there's a lot of Boston and New York people down there the week after. It's a lot of great shit going on. So make sure you come out to my shows and buy your tickets and everybody's show. I got this great app that I'm involved in, too, called Laughable. Right here. It's amazing. If you haven't downloaded it yet, make sure you check it out. You want a little tech talk before you check out. It's just a fucking great app. It's a podcast comedy app. I'm involved with these guys. And the great thing about it is this. So if you go to, you know, say you go to Bert Kreischer, okay? You go to Bert Kreischer, and then you go to his podcast, and it shows you all the other podcasts he was on.
Oh, that's cool.
I don't know if you can see that. Handy, yeah. So it's if you go to him, it shows that he was on Ari Shaffir's show, Resident Evil. He was on This Life, 65. All the other shows, plus his shows. He was on Crab Fest, the Joe Rogan podcast, and it's all right in here. So it's almost like a you get into like a vortex or of podcasting. So you go to one person, and you can go down. Like Chris Rock. Chris Rock was on all the podcasts he's been on are right under his name. Laughable. It's an app. It's free. And I think it's the future of podcasts, comedy podcasts, because it's going to give you the... it's going to show you everybody that's involved in it. So check it out. I mean, I'm on this thing. Everybody. Tracy Morgan, Bill Burr, Laughable. Get the app today. Unbelievable. Cool. And also, I want to thank the people that Hydrate Sparks. This water bottle has been helping me out because I don't drink enough water. That's the problem. I'll drink coffee all day and no water. This thing right here, it lights up. It tells me when to drink. It's hooked up to my phone. It tells me how much I should drink all day. And it's pretty amazing. So you want to talk tech, this fucking thing is the newest in tech. It's Hydrate with an I. And look, it glows. It glows and tells me when I got to take a nice little sip. And then it knows how much water. It comes up right on the app how much I just drank and tells you to keep going. And it just reminds you to have a little water all day. It's pretty cool. What else do we got?
Oh, they can also get the Robert Kelly's You Know What Dude app on the iOS Store, Google Play Store, and the Go Premium and enjoy the exclusive content there.
Go Premium. That's a good shirt. Go Premium.
Yeah.
We should get those made.
Oh, we're doing merch.
We're doing the Go Premium shirts. We got a bunch of other merch coming out. What else you got? What do you got, Lauren, besides?
If you're a fan of the show,
yes.
Please email me at ykwdproducer@ryecast.com and I will get back to you.
I'm sorry. I'm just looking at Lewis getting fat again. It makes me happy. I'm glad you're back. We're at the same spot.
No, are you crazy? I'm not as fat as you.
Pick your shirt up.
No, or you pick your shirt.
Do it.
Like 10 times.
Just pick it up.
You pick it up.
Two fatties just scared. All right, let's go. Come on. Dan put his coat on. I want to hug Dan before he leaves. Let's go.
Take a photo.
What do you got? Is that it?
At Lauren Cabrera.
What do you got, Deeps?
At R2 Depot. And my mom took me to a psychic when I started doing comedy. I wanted to just mention that. And
What did she say?
So my mom asked the psychic, like, will he be good at comedy or something? Like, you know, will he succeed or whatever? Yeah. And the guy looked at me. I guess he was kind of just doing like an eye check, kind of see my, you know, eye contact. Uh-huh. He was like, he will be on TV one day. That's
really?
What he said. Yeah.
That's great. I hope it's not for fucking killing everybody in this room one day.
That's what I'm afraid of.
So. Hey, man. All right. Well, great job again.
Yeah.
What are you guys? What's your name?
What's your one name?
Sawyer.
Sawyer and Vito.
Vinny.
Did you guys have a good time?
It was awesome.
Man, thanks for coming in. I really appreciate it. Are you guys premium members?
Actually, no.
Well, someday you can be. I think you're a little young to fucking... Maybe you don't have the money. But if you ever do, become a premium member. If not, just keep listening, man. We really appreciate you guys supporting the podcast and everybody on it, all right?
Yeah, thanks for coming.
Thanks for coming in,
thanks
man.
Thanks for having us.
You got it, man. Awesome. We'll give you a little poster after. You want us to sign it?
Sure.
All right, I'll see you guys later. That's it. Another YKWD. And hey, Keith, I just want to say, you know what, dude?